This is Grab Bag on Hyper RPG. This is a special game show where we make board games from board games featuring guest developers. Help me bamboozle the audience, guys. So why don't you introduce yourself?
Hi, I'm Gabby. I'm from Lone Shark Games. I am a puzzle designer and game designer and event designer there.
Oh my gosh, you design all the designs.
I design everything.
Yes. Awesome. And?
Hi, I'm Nathan Evers. I work at the University of Washington at a place called the Digital Future Lab. We make games too. I'm an art lead there. I manage students, and we put out some pretty awesome, cheap, affordable video games for the whole family. So check us out.
Awesome. So you design everything, and you design the future. Beautiful. Are you art the future?
I art the future.
You art the future.
We have other
Amazing.
Designers.
So my name is Malika. I'm also a game developer, host of this show, and we are waiting for one more surprise guest. They are going to be arriving very shortly, so I guess it's like a surprise. There was four possible themes that were in the running. They were celebration, ritual, heartbreak, and hesitation. And last time I checked, and maybe somebody could double check for me, ritual was in the slight lead, so that may be the theme of today's show. Are you ready?
I think so.
I dig it.
Awesome. And we're actually missing two guests right now. That means you guys are awesome. Just saying.
Emily?
Yeah?
Ritual did actually win.
Okay, Ritual is a winner. And if somebody has my hourglass, that's a helpful, you know, tool that I like to have. I'm just gonna ignore that because it didn't sound important. Since you're from Lone Shark Games, we have this lovely gem.
I do have that.
Do you wanna talk about it at all?
Sure.
Whoa! Rai to the rescue! This is actually a real hourglass. If you break it, you buy it, because this is my personal hourglass. And it's actually an hour, so we'll be able to turn it twice.
Got it.
But anyways, we were saying, what is Lords of Vegas, for those of you who don't know?
Lords of Vegas is this excellent game. It was actually designed by Mike Selinker and James Ernest, neither of whom are here. You got me instead. I didn't actually work on this game
at all. What a disappointment, the designer of all things.
Can't design everything all the time. But I did do some playtesting on the expansion Up, which is super excellent. So this game, you're placing tiles, you're building a casino, you're rolling dice, there's a little bit of gambling, you can do some crazy trading action. Like, it's got stuff for everybody. And the expansion Up, you literally build your casinos up higher, which I love.
Oh, cool.
The
like
idea of
Vegas.
Playing with
oh,
space,
hype.
And you're like actually mimicking real Vegas.
So this is really interesting.
Yeah.
So I forgot to tell you some of the requirements of the finished product.
Okay.
So not only do we have 2 hours to finish the game, we also have half an hour to play test the game with our Hyper RPG friends in the office. So it has to be a game that can be played within half an hour, taught, okay. That kind of thing. It must include a board, so not all these games have boards. Okay. It must include cards, some of these games have cards, and it must include pieces. I think maybe we should use these pieces. It must include all games, so
okay.
We can't just like pick and choose, we have to include all games. Another thing is this wheel. Do you guys know about the wheel?
I just learned about this. Yeah.
You just learned about the wheel?
Minutes ago.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, this is where the fun begins. I guess carrots is now a permanent addition, but anyone in the chat room can pay $25 to spin the wheel. And the point is to make it harder for us. But we're all pro game devs. Exactly. Right now the wheel is blank, so let's, you know, fill in the wheel with things that would be an entertaining challenge, shall we?
Oh my God.
For example, last week, one that I think went pretty well was include carrots in your game. Another one that I think went pretty well was for, is it 5 minutes or 10 minutes? Joe, what do you think? 5 minutes or 10 minutes? You can only communicate with hand gestures and interpretive dance. Joe says 10 minutes, we're gonna do 10 minutes. So I'm gonna re-add that one. 10 minutes. No talking.
If we knew ASL, we would be set, but I do not, so.
I know.
I don't have any telepathy powers either, okay. So we're at a disadvantage.
But you're an artist, and you like art the future, so.
Right. It's true.
You've got
creativity. Oh, by the way, since this episode actually has an artist, we have some awesome blank cards so that you can do your art farts on them.
I will art fart over these cards. I love this.
So any suggestions for the wheels, guys? Any suggestions for the wheels? Also, there's a little delay.
Okay.
There's Sharky on there.
Oh yeah, Sharky has to be on there. We're gonna pick a nice blue wedge, and definitely we have a little shark costume, as you are familiar. You're from Lone Shark Age. So Gabby has quite generously agreed to put on the Sharky costume if it lands. Hey, you can get a shirt turn in the Sharky costume too. There's a Sharky costume
it's for
sure.
Everybody.
For sure. If it's big enough, I think we could probably tag team.
I think it's one size fits almost everybody.
Sorry, oh, excellent. Zombie Galactus too. Zombie Galactus.
Zombie Galactus.
We saw a request for Zombie Galactus.
Okay, I'll put it over here. What does that mean?
It's that giant HeroClix figure.
Oh.
Big ol' Zombie Galactus.
I know exactly what you're talking about. So that will probably be inputted into our game. I think another one that people really like is Jenga. We have giant Jenga in the studio.
I remember the Jenga from last time.
Did you also roll spin Jenga last time?
Well, we didn't spin it. It was hoisted onto us.
Oh, yes.
We didn't get a choice in the matter.
All right,
this
well.
Is pre-wheel days.
This might happen again. That looks like a stick of butter, but I was going for a Jenga.
Nope, that's beautiful.
You want to art it?
Nope.
Okay. Next week, butter Jenga?
Yeah.
Ooh, suggestion. Add an Apocrypha-style memory fragment. Memory fragment?
Yeah.
We got some fans here. All right.
I like the way you think.
That's the chat room. That was actually Elaki, a suggestion from Elaki. Thank you. Anyways, other suggestions. Thanks. Maybe one could be that you refer to yourself in third person for 10 minutes.
What's the punishment for not doing so?
Malika thinks you should always follow the suggestions of the wheel.
The wheel is law.
Wheel is life.
Great.
All right.
I don't know, maybe you have to put on the shark costume?
Bludgeoning with the wheel every time you mess up.
You know what? I think this could be for the whole show. The whole show? I'm just gonna say third person. All right.
That is our punishment.
Somebody loves that you have to include some kind of plot history or lore for your game. Because a lot of people come up with mechanics. I like that one.
Okay.
So I'm gonna say plot / lore. Anybody else? Punishment is two spins of the wheel. Yes, exactly, Severus. That's a great suggestion.
Someone recommended rhyming for 10 minutes.
Rhyming for 5 minutes. Okay, 10 minutes.
Speaking
10
nothing
minutes?
But rhymes.
Speaking nothing but rhymes.
So it gets very quiet.
But is it okay
just get revert
if you
to
just
like sign language
say one
point?
Word? Because then you don't have to challenge yourself by coming up with a word that rhymes, right?
I just follow the rules. Someone has to make them.
Speak in rhyme. Alright, I also like this. FFX Master, I like the arm tie behind the back from last week, but these devs haven't been so glutinous for punishment? Is that what it is? Alright, so last week, somebody rolled arm tie behind their back, and we were all tied, so we'd have to kind of, not me, but the devs.
Sure.
All right, but I'll participate this week.
We'll
so.
Do that.
All right, so arm tie. It's really hard to write a circle.
Have to use puns for 5 minutes.
Oh no!
So in. I love you, pun person.
Literally the worst.
Okay. Be punny. I'm gonna write be punny. See what I did there? All right, we got one, two, three more suggestions, anybody? Oh, thank you for resubscribing. That's awesome. That's what the 7 months for. It's somebody who has continued to support our channel.
Cute.
Awesome. Didn't Malika basically just stand us on a box last week? Pretty much, but now I'm on the ground and I'm the shortest person on camera. Thank you very much. No Apple box, no high heel. This is my true height. Yeah, by the way, for people who are watching, lurking, for our guests who don't know, this is a community-supported and driven channel.
A new challenger approaches!
A new challenger approaches!
Ian
Birdsall.
Mr. Ian!
Hi, everybody. Birdsall. Sorry, it's impossible to find a cup of coffee in this town.
What?
Welcome, welcome.
Hi.
Why don't you introduce yourself?
Hi, I'm Ian. I'm actually just on vacation here, but I guess
you're
technically I work for Asmodee, organized play for, you know, fantasy play games and Days of Wonder and the Asmodee group and all that stuff. Yeah, excited to be here. Patrick from Uncle's Games is setting up a convention called the Evergreen Tabletop Expo.
That's
which
right.
I am here kind of in support of today.
And you will be there too.
I'll be there.
And
yeah.
I will be there.
Fun.
Are you going to be there?
I'm probably going to be at
home
sleeping.
Come on.
Sleep is good.
Yeah, it can be good from time to time.
Oh, yeah, it starts tomorrow, goes for a few days. It was a Friday, Saturday, Sunday. It's down in Tacoma at the Tacoma Convention Center.
Awesome.
So, yeah, if you're free, you should come
Y'all should definitely come because we're going to be here and we're going to try to convince this guy to come too.
We're all beautiful, fun people.
And on Saturday, I'm actually doing official coverage. So, if you want to be on camera again and be around me, just look for me on Saturday, I guess. All right.
Nice.
So we're in the, do you know how the show works? The show is very simple. You make a board game from board games in 2 hours.
Ooh, and some of my favorites are here as well.
Exactly. So I chose those so that you could talk about them.
But wait, there's more.
Oh,
oh
my goodness.
Come on.
Hi there. Your name is.
Isn't the Emperor's March supposed to be playing as Zach comes here?
Yeah, that was part of the agreement.
Yeah.
How are you guys?
Hi. What's your name?
I'm Zach.
You should look at the camera that has the red light.
Have you ever done this before? Do you know much about media?
I've never been on video ever.
No, never once.
It's okay.
I'm just kidding. I'm on video a lot.
Awesome.
That's a lot of sarcasm.
Hi, I'm wonderful. Zach. Okay. So we're going to make a board game from these board games. We have 2 hours. Right now we're designing this wheel. $25, and the chat room spins the wheel, and then we have to do what it says on this wheel section.
Okay.
Got it? Ooh. You bet. All right, so right now we have things like we have to include the Zombie Galactus HeroClick. I guess I should have drawn the
Zombie Galactus HeroClick. I have one of those on my desk.
Or include Jenga.
I love that thing.
Or the Memory Fragment from Apocrypha. Also, don't mean to be rude, but I'm going to be rude. Cross chatter sounds horrible for everybody watching at home, so we're gonna take turns talking. So when you get to talk, nobody else talks.
She holds the conch, man.
All right. So we're running out of time to actually design the game. So we have three more sections. Any suggestions from the chat room? Dance party for 5 minutes. Love it. We're gonna do a dance party for 5 minutes. Dance. Just dance.
Great.
Dance.
I really hope we spend that one.
All right, and then, well, one of them is actually to put on a Sharky costume.
Oh.
I'm like Left Shark, and
I volunteered.
She volunteered because she's from
Lone
Shark Games, and good luck trying to touch actual game pieces on the table wearing that thing. I hope you guys donate so we can make that happen. limit each person. One can't use hands. One can't talk. One is blindfolded. I'm not sure of the fourth. Okay, so we already have some of these. One is don't talk, use only hand gestures. I think some people like blindfold. That's one we've used in the past.
Can we get like a big inflatable bat, like an UGG tech for the, you know, using gestures thing?
Sure. Anything in the room you can use.
Yeah, pretty much.
Do you know Morse? You can like tap it out.
I do. as a puzzle nerd.
I can pretend
okay,
that I
okay, I like this musical chairs. Everyone switch spots while Joe's plays music. All right, I like musical chairs. All right, musical chairs.
That one can get, like, super duper.
Oh my goodness. Let's get this started. Spin the wheel, please. I'm gonna spin the wheel.
Let's get this started. Spin the wheel, please.
Actually, first, I'm gonna start the hourglass. This is a real hourglass. It will be an hour. It's my hourglass. Don't break it. I will hurt you.
What do we have an hour to do?
We have 2 hours to make a board game.
We're gonna make a board game out of board games.
Oh, by the way, the chat room voted on ritual as our theme. So the game has to include pieces from all these games.
The theme has to be
ritual. The theme has to be ritual. And it has to include this now. So here we go.
Wheel of morality. Turn, turn, turn.
Alright, so we're gonna dance for 5 minutes. Okay. Somebody start the clock, Joe. Can we start designing while we dance?
So should we like design while we dance?
Yeah, we have to design while we dance.
There's actually a two-way switch box. Okay.
This is what I was
born to do.
Where's
the dance music? 5 minutes.
Oh, absolutely.
All right. So Android Netrunner and Star Wars X-Wing, two of my absolute favorite games. X-Wing, you might be a fan.
Oh, this is so good.
I think you like Star Wars.
I've heard of it.
So one last rule. I think we also like switch locations. Yeah. We have to have a board. Cards, pieces, and
I like that board.
Right?
I think
it's also the only one with a board.
Probably true. So we have.
Boarded up. We also have the Maze of Games.
The Maze of
novel.
Games, okay. Great. It is the Maze of Games.
I just kind of want to do this for the entire 2 hours.
I'm not sure how we're going to incorporate it.
It's kind of hard to.
We'll put a puzzle in the game. I got this.
But yeah, it's a bunch of little different.
I think
it's a grown up activity book, really.
Just challenge me.
I think we could maybe use a page.
That's important.
All right.
They're saying more dancing.
Oh, more dancing?
Sorry.
And tokens and rocks.
This is like sand. It's going to become snow. Yeah, thanks. Sandstorm's going to be stuck in my head. Thanks a lot, guys. So we have Vegas, the board game. The theme is rituals. Something forming in your head, guys, yet?
Oh, absolutely. I think we should have a cooperative, right? We're all trying to put together something to complete a ritual.
When I think of rituals, I think of serial killers, so co-op serial killer game.
I'm not right. Okay, yeah.
I'm down for that. Okay.
I'm suddenly way more uncomfortable.
Yeah. Sorry.
For whatever reason, on a ritual,
I'm dancing.
Like, every idea is great.
Rituals that you do, not like creepy rituals, but like.
Oh, absolutely not. No.
You know how you have a ritual before a game starts, kind of thing.
It's really hard.
Oh yeah, like.
Okay, and then we have to incorporate these blank cards in somehow. All right. So.
All right, we got dice.
I can make the heck out of some stick figures.
Oh!
What does that noise mean?
Holy cow!
What?
Sharky co-op cereal.
Okay, so we have to spin this five times.
Five times? No, it says one spin on the wheel. Oh my gosh!
Okay. Hashtag Horizon has learned about an unsigned man on hashtag Defa. Also, one spin on the wheel, please.
One spin on the wheel, please.
Oh, thank you.
All right, here we go.
Oh, no.
Yeah, I thought there was music. Is that only one happening?
Yeah.
Oh, musical chairs.
Musical chairs.
So,
all right.
So every time the music plays, we have to
switch to where we are. Okay.
Right, we're forced to switch spots.
Every time. Okay. This is like Mad Hatter's Tea Party. Yep.
Okay. Running with scissors.
Do we keep going until the music stops? Is that
like,
all right?
Okay.
Good.
Okay.
Netrunner, no.
Oh no!
Okay. More of the moving.
Yep.
All
right. Moving.
Oh, this is already annoying.
We should be.
Never gonna open
it.
No, never fear, guys. This is gonna work.
Okay. I think the music's still going.
Oh, there's Netrunner.
The more you say it, the more I believe you.
All right. So should we just? Are we just opening everything now?
That's where I'm going.
Yeah, punch out some tokens. So, okay, have we decided to go with the co-op serial killer game?
Yep.
Like, okay, are we trying to catch a serial killer? Are we trying to work together?
I think we are the serial killers.
We're the serial killers.
It's like a
we're co-oping to pull off of.
Okay, so we're like...
The biggest serial kill of all time.
Yeah. Or maybe...
Like
maybe,
that first season of How to Get Away with Murder.
How many kills can you get in a row with before you get caught, right?
Wait a second, guys. The theme is ritual. What's the ritual? Getting ready to murder people?
No, the ritual is... what you do while you're murdering someone.
Right.
Yeah, where, so, yeah, like, but yeah, like Dexter, where you have to have, like, the...
You, have, like, you know how you have, like, a pregame? Yeah. Before, like, have them on the
before the serial killer?
Oh, my goodness. I'm just gonna...
All right, well, we have these brain tokens,
which
represent brain damage in the game of Netrunner.
Right.
But perhaps they can, you know, our serial killer
can do
something with brains.
Out.
Right. We also have like all the different Vegas casinos. Maybe they're in Vegas doing this.
We went to Vegas.
You can definitely see serial killing happen in Vegas.
Right?
Yeah, absolutely.
I'm like on my toes because I'm like, oh my god, they're gonna play that music
again.
What if
the game where one hidden killer and everyone trying to catch them? That's kind of what I was thinking a little bit when we.
Okay.
But aren't we the killer that people are trying to catch?
Kind of a.
Well, if we
a
wanted,
Mr. Jack sort of thing, or
I think if we wanted to do a co-op thing, it would make more sense to be like a bunch of detectives trying to find the serial killer who's killing people in a ritualistic manner.
Yeah, right. Okay.
You have a gift for me.
Yep. But, just leave that there.
These are my growths. the doctor said it's benign. It's fine.
Okay. Yeah. It's very fluffy.
So, please don't touch it. That's not.
Oh, sorry.
That's not how consent works.
Shut up. To Uncle's Games, who gave us these brand new games to use on the show.
Okay, so character pieces. Would we like to have, you know, obviously we want to move characters around.
Yes, so well, let's see. The game of Netrunner comes with IDs.
Okay.
And we also have ships. Let's see here.
Sure, maybe we're just cruising around in TIE Fighters in Vegas.
We could be Hacker Extraordinaire, known as Noise.
I like what you're doing here.
Kate McCafferty. Friends call her Mac.
Well, music shares is really fun for me. I have to keep it just in case. Damn it!
And Gabriel Santiago.
Alright.
So there's three choices. Or those could be our potential victims.
Oh, yeah.
As well.
Truth.
Maybe, yeah. Each time you get a victim, you get a little bit more information about the serial killer's ritual. So you get closer to finding them.
Alright.
Well, that's maybe interesting, yeah.
We're all very quiet now. Dead air.
Thinking time.
Yeah, so
no, wait,
we have,
you don't
we have
summon
a puzzle book. Have
okay, we
incorporated that yet?
That's how we done. That's how we
sorry,
on
which one? Right. Which
the
which
puzzle
element?
Book? Right, so there's something about...
Alright, give me a page to flip to.
There's something about...
So
this is where we're going to go.
The main character of the Maze of Games is this guy called the Gatekeeper, who's very much like Jigsaw. He's a little less murdery, but he's all like, I'm going to suck you into this thing, do some puzzles, make yourselves better now. So this is the Gatekeeper. He's kind of the villain. He'd make a good serial killer to catch. I don't know.
So we're going to use the Gatekeeper.
Oh, also there's a bookmark.
Oh,
yeah. How are you going to incorporate this?
Oh, let's use the bookmark.
Yeah, use the bookmark.
There you go. Yeah.
It's excellent.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Sold.
Yep, done.
So, alright, so,
we've got all these chips, the bad guy, the good guy.
Well, these could be some sort of vehicle. They could be player characters.
Mm-hmm.
I kind of like the idea of patrol cars just sort of cruising around in some fashion.
Okay.
Maybe they're NPCs, maybe they're controlled by one player. I don't know, it depends on like how we want to build this.
Yeah, I just had a vision of TIE Fighters coming down on the strip in Vegas.
Yeah.
Okay.
Which, the Vegas I want to be in.
We could roll a die and then rotate this a certain amount of ways and that's how they move on the board.
Okay. Maybe they're...
I don't know if that's too many moving parts.
Maybe there's something with like each part of the grid being like a crime
on.
Scene.
Oh,
so
yeah.
When they're like adjacent or like on something, they can...
Okay.
Care so, or flip something, maybe?
How do we win this game?
Do you want to work that way, or we kind of work backwards?
what is our goal?
You always need an objective, Zach.
When I'm explaining a game, you typically start at the end, which is how do you get to the end?
Right.
Because that gives you context for everything else.
Right.
That's a great idea.
Yeah,
we all have specific objectives where there could be multiple winners. We're all trying to work together for a primary objective, but we all have secret objectives.
Sure.
There's a comment in the chat room. I really like the idea of a team of serial killers trying to compete their to complete their rituals. If you wanted to give different players different secret roles, you do have a bunch of blank cards that you could use if you wanted to show, if you wanted to do it that way. So that, yeah, that's an option. True.
Like, yeah, you win if you eat more
alien
cannibals.
Abduction murder rituals.
Well, you know, it's like,
I like that idea. Idea a lot, actually. Alien abduction murder rituals. Like, there's different kinds of aliens. They've invaded into Vegas. And maybe they're, like, searching for a specific person. Like, a bartender, a blackjack dealer, a dancer. Like, maybe that figures into their ritual somehow.
Okay,
like,
the aliens need to abduct somebody.
Right.
We need to find and terminate this person before they abduct this person, which will end the world.
Yeah, okay. We have to terminate the person.
Yep.
Sure.
It's the only way.
We can't keep them safe.
We can't keep them safe from the aliens. This person has secret knowledge that the aliens need to dominate the planet.
We can't be
so
aliens.
We have been, you know, we are serial killers that have been let loose, and the police have given us free rein to find and kill this person.
Imagine the TV show about the serial killer, and they connect the dots finally, and he's killing people based on aliens' needs.
Yeah, oh my gosh!
The reason that all this is connected is like, it seems
those are the dots.
Because it's like, it's this random 18-year-old girl, and then it was an old man, and then it was a casino dealer, and it's like us just stopping aliens from evading.
No, that's great, yeah. The aliens are, like, that's why they abduct people. They're abducting people of every single profession to build out their alien Wikipedia entries.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That's it.
So I have a question. Brilliant. How many players? Because I feel like that would be how many roles. Also, this game needs
to be
taught and played within 30 minutes after our two-hour kind of round. So I know there are a few people out there, but we can't make a game that requires 20 people. Don't have that many.
Say 3 to 6, 3 to 5.
3 to 6, 3 to 5. Okay, so we have enough to kind of like play test and prototype as we design right now. Okay. Alien abduction, murder, scavenger hunt, ritual, slip and slide.
Do we have a slip and slide?
Can we put that on the board?
Yeah, if somebody wants to donate,
hose us down,
then
just
$25.
I volunteer as tribute. Alright, so we've thrown out a lot of ideas here. What did we actually settle on? So I think we've stuck with that we are going to be serial killers, right? Or the players are going to be.
Right. Is that true?
That's what I thought, but I feel that, like, maybe I may have misunderstood it, so.
I'm resonating with aliens.
We are the aliens, or the players. When I say we, I mean the players.
I don't know.
Right. Well, we also started cooperative, but maybe we aren't going to end there. Because there could easily be an alien player, a top player trying to find the murderers,
ooh,
and then
like
the rest of the players are trying to kill whatever the alien is trying to abduct. So it's...
Holy cow.
There's some hidden information, right? You have one player whose role is alien, who all they're trying to do is abduct somehow.
Right.
And they win by abducting that person. You have the group of players, the team, that is trying to essentially murder whatever it is the alien's trying to abduct. There might be multiple of those on the board, right? It's like, I need a female that's under 25.
So we're all trying
creepy
to find... We're all trying to...
Yeah,
you always...
It's just demographics.
Yes. All right, sorry. You're just jumping up and down.
Okay, so I'm thinking that we have all these blank cards. We can use them as character cards for people who just exist on the board, right?
They're all flipped over
on the other side, and then you're trying to get to these places, and then depending on what's actually on the card, like, it could be a profession, it could be...
Like a Chippendale or something?
Exactly, yeah, yeah. You might even have, like, multiple different descriptors for a character.
Circus
and based on
clown.
Yeah, and then based on, like, whatever your starting hand is, or based on whatever cards you get, like, that's what you're trying to find before other people
and
before
the like, a female and someone else who's under X and someone who's a casino dealer. And that might be a single character.
Yes, this is great.
It could also be three different
characters. Yeah, okay.
Yeah. Okay. Do you think you have enough time to draw that many
Well,
cards?
We could, not beautifully, but we can certainly do that.
I am an expert
stick figure with the bow.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so the alien would need to, let's say in this hypothetical situation, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, we'll just do 5 descriptors, right? Mm-hmm.
I think
the murderers
are drawing, maybe.
Is this camera up here?
Yeah, so we have a camera.
Yeah, that's a good question.
so that the chat room can see what you're doing.
Joe, where are the camera edges so that we know when we're showing
Say
things?
Inside this
you
table?
Know, I like okay. this. So Steve here is saying, can players be abducted by aliens? I think if each player also has
a trait.
Their own traits.
Yeah,
right.
And they can be abducted
yeah,
by aliens.
That's interesting. Mm. Yeah.
Let's,
or murdered.
Finish
or murdered, by the way.
Or just yeah. like, or just avoid the yeah. thing. Like, right. if it crosses paths, then you're just out or something like that. Like, that could be super simple. That one.
Cool.
Okay, so let's say that an alien needs to find one character that has, like, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 descriptors.
Sure.
Whereas the players, the murderers, or the people who are just trying to, like, find the people before the aliens, they only require a card that has like one of them, but they have to find like 5 of those people.
Okay.
So the alien is looking for a really, really, really specific card, whereas the player win condition is to find like 5 that are relatively easy to pick up, right?
Okay, I have 2 suggestions.
Yes.
You can take them or not. I think we should use these brains to signify that they've been abducted by aliens.
Absolutely.
And another thing is, I'm kind of confused already, and
sure.
I think all players should play the same role, or there should only be one different player. Because I'm confused, like, who are aliens? Who are... Yep. Yeah.
Should we just say the players are the aliens, and they're just trying to find specific people to abduct?
I like the idea of having one player have maybe they would only be murderers, maybe we can be investigators trying
right.
to find this person.
Right.
So everybody needs to find this person, but one person is an alien trying to abduct that person.
Okay.
So they want right. they want to be the person that finds it first.
So kind of like
interesting.
So Spyfall or like one
like
of those
a bit of a traitor mechanic.
Yeah.
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 So 4 players, one of them is the alien, but you're all kind of trying to share information
yep.
because there can be one winner if you hit all of your cards or something like that.
Yeah, well even if you just know that one of the 4 people is an alien,
yep.
then
yeah.
it's sort of like when you're playing Resistance or whatever,
mm-hmm.
you're
right,
always
right.
suspicious of everybody.
Or like,
right.
werewolf.
It's
yeah.
like,
we
it's
all,
like
we all,
no,
yeah.
don't let Zach go there, he's just gonna...
Yeah. We all have the same goal, right?
Yeah, we all have to find this person.
We can't let the person
okay.
that is the alien be the one that finds the right,
right.
person.
Mm-hmm. Right,
got it.
Okay. Meanwhile, we are role-playing regular people in Vegas, who aren't regular, I guess, because they're kind of fabulous over there.
They can be. Depends on like the
That's
part
true.
Of Vegas.
Now,
yeah.
is this like, you know, heyday, like, you know, 50s Vegas, or?
I don't know.
This is future Vegas.
This
we
is
can,
future.
This is the utopia Vegas.
Vegas.
It can be whatever you want
regular?
To be.
So this is regular? Like,
yeah.
this is
sure,
not
yeah.
out of the like, ordinary?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So some people have Teslas, some people have those things.
Yeah,
right.
This is Jabba's Vegas city on Tatooine or something like that. Or it's owned by
what's
the Hutts.
What's the gambling planet in Star Wars?
I mean,
well,
it's
just like
yeah,
but
that's
but they have
Narshada.
Yeah.
There's a few.
Narshada. Narshada's kind of scummy place.
Comments from the chat room. Steve Aris says, "Yeah, but punishing a player by having something they might not be able to control, like an alien crossing their path and they're out, could be seen as a negative experience unless the game is really short. Body snatcher, traitor, and then some people are saying we're grabbing ideas from Dead of Winter, which
I've
okay
never
with
played
that.
Dead of Winter."
Yeah, well, Dead of Winter, Battlestar Galactica,
mm-hmm.
The Resistance.
It's
lots of games
mechanic.
Have
sure.
some have some sort of traitor mechanic where
yeah.
you, there's a hidden role, somebody who's trying to sabotage and or win at the expense of everybody else. But I do agree with, I don't think player elimination leads to a good player experience. So,
sure.
yeah.
so perhaps if we do want something like that, it would be like they miss a turn or they discard their hand or whatever we get
right.
there. Like, there can be a penalty, but not they're not eliminated from the game.
So, one thing that I love to do when I first design a game is role play. So since you took off your bunny ears, I say you role play the traitor, the actual alien, right? And we will role play what the innocent humans, detectives that are trying to, but like we don't know that. And so how does this game start? Do we pick 4 corners on the board? That would be kind of easy. Or do we roll? Or do
there
we start on the same
three,
square?
Four, six, there are 6 quadrants.
Yes.
Right.
yeah, I don't know.
Do you guys want to just go with corners on the board and
then we
adjust?
Work from there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
We each start in one of the 4 corner quadrants.
Right. What
okay.
are the player pieces? Right now, are they cards? You're gonna draw.
I think the cards might be a little intense.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
For placing on the board, do
these
we have
are,
something else
I mean,
that
these
we can use?
Are the board size?
Yeah.
They come in multiple
are
colors.
Are these astronauts? I'm jiving with the astronauts.
Whoa.
And this is a dragon with a hole in it.
Oh, okay.
There's like the SeaWorld casino. There's
sure,
like
yeah, the Saturn. Dragon yeah. casino.
Dude, four pieces that look
aliens.
Similar enough but different.
This yeah. is our trader piece.
The trader piece?
This is the trader piece.
Do they all have the same
back? They all have
back?
The same, they all have similar back. I don't know if it's exactly the same.
Because if we're going to do a trader piece, colored. We should try and have something that is...
Yeah, they don't have the same backs.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, we could just use, like, four tokens that look the same. We can just draw a little, you know, a little gray
sure.
on the back of one of these.
These might be open.
Yeah.
There's
only
two
of those.
They're kind of hard to see.
Yeah.
Oh, there's only two.
There's only two of those.
All right. So, which one are the player pieces?
I think we're still trying
maybe,
to figure
maybe
that
these,
out.
Maybe these, because these are nice and primary colored, so they'll like
okay,
show really
sure.
well.
That sounds
okay,
good.
And then
that's
we just
so
have a
cool.
something on one of them, or perhaps
yeah.
Oh, yeah, so there's a player of pieces that doesn't
cool.
matter, and then
yeah.
we have
okay.
cards that we assign roles to.
Yeah.
yeah. There we go.
By the way, for anybody who's just tuning in, this is Grab Bag. This is when we take guest developers and board game lovers. And we make a new board game out of existing board games. And we got 2 hours to do it. I'd say about 20 minutes are gone. So, good
Excellent.
Luck.
I mean,
yeah.
Now
people
you
who aren't in the industry might not know that most games are designed in under 2 hours.
Yeah,
that's,
yeah.
That's
absolutely.
Just, that's
yeah.
just a fact.
We just pillage from other board games.
Mm-hmm.
But pieces,
no.
So
no testing.
They take a long time to balance, yeah. so no promises there.
We do half hour of testing, and that's
yeah.
it. Just straight to retail.
Okay, do we right. want to have only four roles, one of them being the alien, or do we want to have more than that, and then we pick one alien and shuffle it with three other ones, so that there can be, you know, different secret powers, different secret abilities, or different secret win conditions for everybody.
Well,
we want to keep them kind of vanilla and not get that
awesome for 2.0.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
I think they should have the same objective.
So we'll start
the
with just
power,
the four.
It's going to make
right.
it obvious because we're aliens.
Also,
yes.
maybe.
But like you could be like in Battlestar Galactica, if you reveal, you get a bonus.
If they know you're the alien.
Yeah, if they know you're the alien.
Or maybe we could just write them all to have the same objective, and if we have time, write an alternate way for them
yeah.
to win. And that could become an additional role. Are you guys drawing the player cards now?
Sure. So there's the alien.
Oh, that's the alien. Okay.
Good job.
I'm such a great artist. Like
I have no idea.
People don't know
like
that
the,
about me.
Yeah.
But
the thing that's great
it's
about these
like,
is the dice are meant to
fit them.
Yeah, exactly.
Resume.
My daughter thinks I draw better than anybody.
That's fair.
Yeah.
A lot of space stuff around here. How are we incorporating this book?
So I could write
well,
a puzzle
this is my,
that
is my
fits
test
into the
to
game.
See if I want to show it on camera.
Yeah,
Joe.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you for
I
that.
I need to make sure drawing with a Sharpie is going to turn out well.
Yeah, that's
cool.
I think I'm just going to go with the alien.
I think Gabby had an idea about Gabby. Okay, Gabby had an idea about how to include this.
We could weave
yes.
a puzzle into the game. We could just use the bookmark.
What if you had to solve a puzzle to progress, like for movement?
Is it just
that's
filled
what
with puzzles?
Do. Oh yeah, it's an entire puzzle.
Yeah,
puzzle.
Yeah. There's
yeah.
like every page has a puzzle, which
yeah,
is incredible.
Yeah, it's like a grown-up activity book.
Oh my gosh.
It's
okay,
just,
are there like ones you can do in 30 seconds?
No.
No. I mean, how?
I mean, for the average bear, no.
Okay.
For puzzle experts, probably.
Okay.
The book starts out easier and it levels you up.
There we go. There's the alien card.
It could just be like we could pick
Artiste.
One of the puzzles that's like a crossword or part of the maze or something, and you just have to solve one clue to progress.
Mm-hmm.
Or it could be like Quidditch or chess boxing, where nice. Either win this game
right,
or
oh.
solve.
Can we just redesign chess boxing and then just do that? Would that be?
Is that acceptable?
I don't know.
It wouldn't fit the theme.
I wouldn't be afraid. Well, I would say there is a ritual to boxing. And chess.
All right, so let's see. We got an alien. We got another character. Zach, would you like to draw one of the different characters? So this looks like
it's a gumshoe.
It's a gumshoe.
Gumshoe.
All right.
You got a person?
It.
Yeah. Do you want to bro in Vegas?
Elaki says I've owned Maze of Games for over a year now and haven't solved a single puzzle.
But is that because you haven't tried?
Yeah, have you opened the book yet? Because
how long? Would
I
you
also
say,
have
like,
not solved
a
single
hours?
Puzzle.
Like a single, like a lot of people do like a puzzle a night, and
okay.
it takes them a few months to get through the whole book.
Okay, that sounds interesting.
Yeah, that's very cool.
So maybe either solve a puzzle from this book or do this. Like, successfully solving this puzzle immediately ends the game.
May I see the book?
Sure, please? Absolutely.
There are definitely some easier puzzles.
Yes. Maybe we can take elements of a puzzle. Not
right, I was like, well, we
could
pull
puzzle.
One of the characters that's mm-hmm. in there, or we could pull the theme of one of the puzzles out.
Cool. So,
there's a big, scary, dapper minotaur at the back.
Yeah.
That's a badass.
Zach.
I do like the artwork.
You
in this
are from Team Covenant. For
I,
those
am.
Of,
I am.
I'm going to step out of later, Zach.
In the audience who don't know what Team Covenant is, can you just tell them a quick how awesome you are?
Yeah, do I have like 30 minutes? I'm just kidding. Team Covenant, we're an online and local tabletop gaming retailer in Tulsa, Oklahoma.
Awesome.
We do a ton of content.
Like uncles?
Like uncles, yes. Like uncles in Wash. But, where are we at right now, Redmond?
We're in the greater Seattle area.
Yes.
Noted.
Okay.
I got in a van and showed up and here
yeah,
I am.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, but we're based out of Tulsa. We do a bunch of YouTube content. So.
Awesome. Yes, I saw that you also stream competitive
Netrunner
and stuff.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
awesome.
100%. So that's what we do.
And Zach is actually a very good player of many of the games that Team Covenant promotes. And
awesome.
That's what he's in town to do. He's in town to win some regionals.
Well,
mostly Star Wars themed.
As a successful competitive tabletop player, if you have the traitor role in that type of game, what's going through your mind? What do you want to achieve? And what is stopping you?
I love being a traitor.
Noted.
100%. Playing Resistance or any game, Battlestar Galactica, I love being a traitor.
Okay.
And it's I always love the fine balance of not, you have information that makes it easier.
Right.
But you cannot give that information without giving away that you're a traitor.
Right.
And so you really want to say, oh, this is the wrong guy. I know it's the wrong guy because I know the information.
Okay.
But I can't say that.
So
it's really hard to do that and be honest about it and make them think that you're being honest. Just sort of like,
my thoughts are that there is a secret map that you get, maybe.
All right.
So maybe that's on the back of your alien card. So there's a secret route through here. And so if you just took that route, everybody is like, well, just follow the alien because he knows where he's going. So that you have to disguise your route. That's just one idea. That's just one.
All right.
Are these cards are they tied to certain areas in here?
Oh,
they are.
Yeah. So
yeah, yeah.
Each one corresponds to one square.
Okay. So.
Yeah. Hmm. In Lords of Vegas, the way you get to place stuff on the board is it's shuffled up in random order, so you don't really get to plan out your thing. You just kind of look into stuff. So
okay.
We could kind of
yeah,
limit that here if we wanted.
Yeah,
for where you explore.
If we're trying to find something on the board,
right.
And I don't know, I have not played this game, so I don't want to have accidentally stolen the idea. But
right.
You can't copyright game mechanics, guys. Right?
You can try.
You can try.
Somebody, Vanderlees, has a suggestion. Since you're attempting to find a match between your hand and the face down cards, in order to claim that match, you have to solve a puzzle from the book. I think there's something there about finding a match between your hand and the face down cards.
Right.
Hmm. Oh, okay. So, another suggestion.
Excellent.
I'm just talking out loud. It's a great skill that developers should foster in themselves, and also a yes and attitude,
detective.
Right? Maybe you're all casino owners, and these are all your employees,
mm-hmm.
and the alien is trying to find, is pretending to buy a casino, but is really just trying to find a specific person in each casino, which is in your hand.
Okay.
You guys feeling that? Yes, no, yes and?
Tristan from Yu-Gi-Oh.
Tristan, I don't know how you spell words, much less names.
Just shuffle letters around and
see sure,
what
yeah.
happens.
Yeah.
Do we have a lounge singer there? All right, I think.
That's like a Frank Sinatra impersonator.
Right.
Oh, I have a really good one.
So okay, so we have the alien, the card that represents the person who is the gray.
Right.
Could have done a Geiger alien, but this is.
Where was the other one? You had a really good one earlier.
Oh, the one that I didn't want to show people, then Joe put on the stream that I then ripped up? That's over there.
That's slightly aggressive.
Well, it's legacy format, really. So, you know, we're on the next stage.
Noted.
I think one thing we could do is continue role playing. Mm-hmm. So, since you've only drawn about, like, one, two, three, four, about five cards right now, how about everybody gets four blank ones? All right.
Deal them out. Two.
Or is that
five? You guys have some. Okay.
Four. Okay.
Do you wanna role play with us too?
Absolutely.
Okay. So we're just gonna hold, like, pretend we have stuff on these, right?
Okay. All right.
And is this oh crap, we have to incorporate the board too.
Yeah.
So maybe to move on the board, you use either your cards or you ask for cards from other people's hands.
Should we have a way that has a hand management sort of thing, so you can play your cards as actions and then you use an action to pick them all back up?
Okay, sure.
Like move to a casino, pay a bribe, fight the alien. I don't know.
I was actually thinking, because the board actually just has die and die results on them. If you rolled a six-sided die or something like that, let's say I'm player green, right? Mm-hmm. I'm player green right here. I'm on three. Mm-hmm. I roll a four, so I can go to any four within this space. Mm-hmm. Or if I'm like kind of near the edge of a casino, I could move into the next one, right? But I can't go like across town like this. Maybe you go
to like an adjacent casino.
Right, maybe your card lets you do that.
Sure. Oh yeah, exactly.
Right.
Maybe you're just
cards that let you move more.
Yeah, you're
move
just
to a
in
casino,
one.
Then casino. Roll a die, and that's the space you started.
Great.
Yeah. Cool.
I think that makes sense.
I think if we could have some kind of mechanic, though, where we're kind of trading and talking amongst ourselves and with each other, because you seem to like the bluffing, right? I know the chat room really likes this kind of bluffing trader mechanic.
That's good.
I usually end up just pointing at people and being like, I don't believe you!
My roommate does the same thing. It's like, you're the traitor, aren't you?
Yeah.
Yes, you are. You're the traitor.
Yeah,
you're the traitor. He's the traitor.
You know, like, I see you're wearing glasses. I can read that you're a traitor. Exactly.
I think that's why I like, so Resistance is really fun, but that's why I lean towards like Battlestar Galactica, where it's not that you're screaming at someone telling them that they're the traitor the whole time.
Right.
But you're trying to gather contextual clues the whole time on who is acting slightly funky, which feels like you're trying to find an alien who's trying to act like a human.
So these are, In the world, we are all detectives, and we know we've been infiltrated, right? Do we or do we not? So are we trying to work together to find?
Do we know that aliens walk among us?
Yeah.
Why not?
Okay.
I think we're in
so we're
put,
trying
put us
to...
at odds with the part everybody at first.
Right. Right. So those of us who aren't the alien are trying to find the alien. I'm thinking that maybe. We're like, hey y'all, Vegas is a big place. So I'm gonna take care of, I'm gonna stay in, and I'm gonna search in this quadrant, so this is represented by my hand. But if I think, Gabby might be the alien or have something going on in her casino, then I go to this part of the map and then we do something with her hand, right? So I'm trying to find a way to connect. I feel like the cards aren't connected to the board enough.
Well, maybe we need to, like, one of our cards could be something like solve a clue that relates to something on the board, right? Mm-hmm. Like, to help you progress.
And maybe that's what these can be. Each space can have one of these,
right.
And then we will have something on it that will...
Hey guys, just a reminder, you're watching Grab Bag. It's a board game made from board games. We got 2 hours to come up with a board game made from all these other parts. If you donate $25, you can spin the wheel and make it a lot more fun to watch the show.
Yeah, I haven't danced.
And a lot harder for us.
It's true.
Just saying. Just giving you ideas.
No. Okay, maybe if we, you can play cards to kind of search spots, and then you cover them up.
Right.
So you play a card to roll, you roll two dice, and then you choose one of those results and go, okay, I'm going to cover up this three.
Okay. But what does that do?
Reveal the three.
Maybe
that searches that room.
What if your hand is a set of actions that you always have access to?
Okay.
And then at the start of every turn, essentially everyone puts an action down.
Right. Sure.
Okay. And like I we like can that. Talk
yeah,
about
yeah,
it.
Yeah, oh yeah. Sure. That's
where
good.
It's like,
sure.
yep. hey, you know, Zach, you need to do this so right. that we can do this. And it's like, okay, I'll do that. And then I flip right. it over and I didn't yep. do that.
Right. Well, we have to put them together and shuffle them up, and then because right. we yeah, don't yeah, know yeah. what person did the traitor
yeah.
thing.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah. But it's like everybody puts.
So you put a card in.
Okay. I like that.
So what are the like actions we want to be
I
static?
I wish I had like move, a whiteboard or right? something
investigate.
Like that.
Investigate. Yeah, so there's move like okay. from a casino to another casino.
Yep.
Then there's like investigate.
Yep.
And
maybe
then
we can waste time by making somebody play craps.
Right. Can somebody from, you know, the engine room provide more materials for the designers here on the bridge? It would be very helpful and appreciated. Just saying.
Alright. What are we doing with these bits?
Well, we don't have to use all the bits.
We don't?
Do we okay, have to use so I don't think we have to use all of them.
Oh, good. So
we have to use them.
That's
crazy.
That is a lot more bits.
I'm gonna play Tiddlywinks by myself over here.
Right.
So you guys
introduce the pog part of the game.
Yeah.
There's a move card, there's a stay, maybe.
So back to the like high level
right.
what are we trying to accomplish?
Uh-huh. We're trying to find that person.
We're trying to find that person. And we all put in a card in the deck, and then we shuffle it.
Well, we're trying to find the person, but what's the alien trying to do?
Yeah, that's a good point. So the
is
alien
trying to still abduct
he's trying to abduct
minds?
People, right?
Right.
So I think the players need to be on that same mission, mm-hmm. but for a different reason.
Right.
So the players are trying to do it to maybe protect people.
How many right. brains do we have?
We have four brains.
We have enough brains.
No, okay. there's more brains right
are there. More brains?
Oh, there's
oh,
more
we
brains.
Have six brains.
Plenty of brains. Okay.
All the brains.
Right.
Where I know the components like, that come into games that I like.
Maybe it's a, so what if it's a specific player that captures a person?
Okay.
And so it's either an alien abducting a person
right.
or it's a player like
trying to protect them.
Trying to protect them.
Oh,
you don't know. So
okay.
that way it's like, oh, Zach has two people. If we let him abduct this last person, he could be the alien that could be game over.
Okay. All right.
So you're trying to like clear the board of certain traits.
Oh,
wow,
yeah.
Wow, this pen is dead.
Oh, that's the kind of materials you needed. Now we have
yes.
Zen pens. Oh. Hey, we have more.
I mean,
magically.
Magic.
Oh, thank
Oof.
You.
I mean, right with mine.
I love the chef.
So we're trying to protect people. And these are different cards we pick up on the board.
These things?
Yeah. Like, are they placed
actually,
on the...
my Twitter is at Ian Birdsall. You can follow me there if you want pictures of my daughter playing board games.
There you go.
Cool.
I think
oh,
these
yeah,
are the
we
people.
Only has one.
That's just, that was done by our moderators.
Was it?
They're actually
oh,
trying
yeah.
to help our audience connect with you guys.
Oh, I see. I
yeah.
see. I just didn't want, like, I just didn't want to...
False Twitter.
Yeah.
I like these
anyway.
Being people representing different traits.
Yes.
That
okay.
you need. So,
yep.
like,
okay.
maybe the alien gets a card at the start of the game that tells him that he's the alien and also says, you need two greens and a blue.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. And then the players have a card, like, are trying to stop that from happening. They're basically trying to figure out who the alien is.
Okay.
I think even at some point, an action yeah. could be pinpoint the alien.
Yep.
And it's like, if you're in the same room as someone, you call a vote.
Right.
And if there's 3 out of 4 votes that say this is the alien, it is, the players win.
Yeah, that works.
Okay.
And as a
but
group,
if you make that
to...
and he's not the alien, then...
Right. How do we
so
do we
how
want to trigger
it.
Game end?
So as a group, I like your idea of collecting different colored tokens. As a group, we need to get a certain number of them.
Right.
Each
right.
game is a little different.
Yeah, yeah. It's a larger number. Right?
It's a larger number,
yeah.
So
like,
and then we
you
all
have to be careful not to.
Yeah,
like the
we
alien.
All we will all individually collect them, but they'll
right.
go into a group pool, so to speak. Mm-hmm. But the alien has a specific objective, and
right.
if they
yeah,
get
yeah
that
maybe it's even like
it's like why do you really want to move there and get that when
why do you want to be the one? That
yeah,
that?
Exactly.
Do
where it's
want,
like so
okay.
it could even just be like 2 of each color as the player group. So you need like 8 tokens, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then the alien it specifically needs 2. So it's unnatural
and
for
this
a player to need the 3rd token.
Movement? Or are you collecting those tokens off the board?
The players are collecting these individually,
okay.
but they're compiled as a group.
Oh,
so the,
okay.
the as a group, we need 8.
Okay.
So as the alien, I can't let the group get 8 before I get the 3 that I need.
Got it.
Yep.
All right.
But then as other players, you don't want anyone to specifically get 3.
Right. Oh, okay.
Because
yeah.
they could be the alien.
Mm-hmm.
But they
right.
could also just be a good guy trying to help,
right.
and it's like,
right.
I can get the 8th token.
Right. Okay, so do we have enough to start, like,
we have a ton.
Sort of playing?
Yeah. Yeah. Right.
Okay. So.
All right, we have all of these amazing characters that have been drawn that I'm not quite sure.
Okay.
What
let's
we're using
put
for.
Them kind of just up here.
So let's just. Who are the three coolest that we've done? Like.
Well, I'm making you, man. So.
Oh shoot.
I feel like.
I should have been. Can I
keep
the whole
that?
Time?
Yeah. You should. Yeah, that's great.
These are like on the milk carton.
Yeah.
Like
right. The people
know.
That we need
yes.
to find.
Yeah. I want an alien. Okay.
Like,
and then
like very
how is the board set up for gameplay?
So.
Do we put tokens all over?
I kind of like these.
Yeah.
Being over the tokens.
Yeah. Oh. Okay.
Where you may not, I don't know how you even set this up logistically speaking before the game, because it's like someone's got to know.
Right. The alien could know.
The alien could know.
But how do you
how many colors we have? 1, 2, 3.
All right,
you just
so,
kick them out of the room.
Or even like somehow, like this gets you a yellow token, but you can't see it. It's just face down.
Right.
I think these are just shuffled up.
Do these match?
Yeah. Well, so there are player colors, and then there are more colors of casino than there are players.
So like, these don't even have to be on the board.
But some could be like wild or something.
Like, so we have yellow, do we have red and green and blue?
We have brown and
magenta. Yeah, we have the
magenta.
Four colors. Of these tokens, we have the four colors of those
green.
Tokens.
Yeah. So I like this. So these get shuffled up and they get put face down.
Yep.
Uh-huh.
And you're finding the things, and the players need to get a certain number of each color.
Right.
And the alien needs to get a very specific.
Right.
Yeah. How do we want to incorporate the dice? Do we want to, once you go into a place, you need to roll that to collect it or to see what it is?
We also have these dice, which are fun. It can be a challenge dice.
And
like,
what
I need
games
more
are we missing
for, like,
stuff from?
What if, like, does having a puzzle element count as using Maze of Games?
What do you guys think?
Let's just play this first and then incorporate the other.
Yeah.
Okay. So, right now, I'm a player. You all are players. Are you in on this round, dude?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. So, we don't get a hand of cards? No. We're just...
So, I thought the hand of cards was a set of actions that everyone has access to.
Okay. So we need to make a set for each of us.
Okay, so move is an option, right?
Okay. Move, solve.
Solve?
Like to flip one over.
Okay.
Gain a token.
Investigate or solve.
Investigate.
Yeah.
However
you want.
Yep. So, flip.
How many of each do we need, do you think?
Four of each.
Okay.
So,
So
we'll
I'll do the solve.
Okay.
Yeah.
Just don't have any pens.
So.
Okay, so then.
Well, somebody could help us and get us some pens, please.
Yeah.
I'm gonna start. Can you?
So we wanna.
How many?
What colors do we want?
Probably just as many of the colors. Yellow, green, purple,
don't have
and silver.
Right. Really.
So we have enough.
Do we need purples? Nice purple is supposed to be the blue.
Thank you so much.
Here's red.
You've journeyed far and long from the engine control room.
Your Sharpies have appeared out of nowhere.
Yeah, I have one.
Alright.
So we have a bunch of these.
I could be helpful.
Okay.
We need other actions.
There are, what, five of us?
So move, solve.
Even with the dice, it could even just be that's you can move that many spaces.
I was gonna.
So move is move to another casino.
I was gonna suggest injecting puzzle element in when you roll the die, like when you flip this over and you get this thing, if you roll the die and you get a 2 from one of the adjacent street name by you, you have to make a 1 to 6 letter word based on the number of dice you've rolled out of the letters in that word.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
No. Sorry.
So
it's like, oh, I rolled a 6 and there are letters in Harmon. If I treat it as a letter bank, which means I can repeat the letters, I don't have to use them uniquely. Mm-hmm. I would have to make a word out of that. I would make, what would I make
out
of that?
Maroon.
Maroon. Yeah, I'd make maroon.
There you go.
Out of that. And then I'd say, oh, I did it. I'm a detective.
And then you get your little piece.
And then I get the piece.
That is your rosebud. Congratulations.
Somebody asked, how is ritual getting incorporated? I might have missed that in my... Okay.
Well, we forgot.
I think this would be super hokey. That round when we put all our cards in and shuffle, that's like when we have like a ritual.
A ritual?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you could even make that ritualistic somehow in the reveal of the cards.
Oh, I think we should, like, connect pinkies and rock and say something.
The sure. Like voting for the alien as the ritual?
Yeah.
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 Alright.
So, okay, so ritual should be one of the four cards. It should have a meaning that we determine.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm down.
Ritual.
Alright, ritual.
Okay. So, what are the other actions we can do? Because solve is the flip. Is there
a non-action card, like a stay or?
Yeah, like, so something that,
stay?
That would right. Necessarily. Because basically stay just means that that we don't do anything that turn. So
right.
That's something that the alien would play over and over again.
We're shifting.
Shifting. Am I spreading here and just kind of pushing
okay.
My way in?
Yeah, I'm gonna step back. There's a lot of us.
It's like piggyback on something.
Yeah, we're <Sad ass. laughs> Huh.
All right, so there are, okay, we got force. Okay, we have stay cards. We have move cards. We have ritual cards. And we have solve. All right, so like flip cards.
Yeah.
Okay, we have more than four.
Maybe even, so on the stay, as a bonus for staying, normally you would have to like solve to flip one over.
Right.
If you stay, whatever casino you're in, you can flip one over. So you know what color it is,
okay.
But you don't
right.
Get it yet. You
oh,
still
okay.
Have to like go
right.
Get
kind
it.
Of,
so now
right.
You
have
know,
to solve.
Now
together.
You know, yeah, now you know if you even want to try to solve.
So I'm gonna right. Say, I'm gonna say.
So solve is not flip.
Yeah,
right.
Flip over.
Stay
and,
is flip.
But no, stay would be like peak. Right?
Yeah, stay
you
like
peek, but you don't
yeah, you
leave
flip
it.
You leave it.
Solve nobody
is
else
like,
knows.
I'm gonna try
okay.
To go for it, and I'm gonna take it
gotcha.
No matter what it is.
Should we have an action that moves these, and these basically block a row that can't be solved?
That's cool.
Sure.
Sure.
Yeah.
Okay.
Line of sight on those
yeah,
things.
Yeah,
yeah.
Yeah. Anything,
well,
anything
you
in
could,
that.
You could,
row.
You could have this guy. Right. You can do this.
Huh.
And
right.
They could move. So
yeah.
These are rows that you can't solve in, but he lets you solve whatever this is.
Right.
So you can't solve this row except for this piece.
Wait a second, that was a lot of information. Everything's getting very complicated. Have you guys played Up the River?
No.
Really? It's a classic board game that board game designers just kind of reskin.
Okay.
It usually has like eight pieces, and every turn, one piece gets removed and added to the top.
Oh,
so the
yeah.
Whole,
oh, okay. Yeah.
Board, so you've seen different versions of it.
Sure.
So if we do have a mechanic like that, I would say it's just very automated and simple. Like
every turn.
Well, I think at the...
Yeah.
I was going to say at the end of your turn, you move them one.
Yeah.
Then
okay.
You have an interesting choice to make as alien or non-alien of...
Okay.
Are you digging someone over by moving this piece
so let's,
or not? Can you do it in the least worst
I'm gonna
way?
I'm
going
to deal these...
And the alien gets a chance to stop
cards
us.
So
okay.
That...
Let's give it
I think we need to... We really need to play test.
Sure.
All right, so that's
right.
One set.
Well, so did these start on the board?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, so let's...
Yes. So they
right.
Should get shuffled
who's missing
up and dealt?
A set?
Me.
Okay.
Now, I also, with the cards, if we want the information to be hidden
oh,
on
yes.
Who's doing
so
what action,
stay.
It's going to be a little awkward because, you know, I put a stay in, and
right.
Then it'll flip, and that's what's revealed.
Uh-huh.
So I almost wonder if it's more, this is a stack of cards.
Right.
They get dealt out.
Right.
We all put a card in, then those actions happen, then we deal those back out, but there's random.
When you say deal
so somebody
back
might
out
get
to...
All...
So like, everyone put a card in.
Okay,
just
so I just put a card in.
It doesn't matter, just put
yep.
A card in.
Right.
Okay, so we take a turn, right?
We have a lot of cards.
All these things happen.
Right.
And then, after the turn's over, these get shuffled up.
Uh-huh.
And instead of everyone get the card, getting the card
you
they put in.
You just get one back.
You get,
one back.
So you could get
so you
multiple the same
sure.
Action.
So then
something.
At some point, maybe it's like, well, it's suspicious that someone put in extra moves, but maybe that's all they have.
Right.
Yeah, so you might
have the optimal thing.
Even if you want to help, your hand might be forced to hurt.
Yeah,
okay. Yeah, that's cool. That sounds fun. All
fun
right.
Is good.
What?
So, stay. Everybody stay. I think because we all did
yeah,
shuffle
just...
Our own hands.
Is that? Do I have cards?
Sure.
There they are.
Okay.
Right in front of me the whole time.
What? Well, how many are these?
There are
so
not
going
to be enough of those to cover everything.
We can use these cards.
No,
we
have
just
a,
like X
I think there's actually
just,
is enough.
Okay. That doesn't help us.
Yeah. It's rough, draft. Yeah.
Well, I think the hole in it doesn't matter because it's the color on the other side that says what player we're getting, right?
Now we're adding in the wrong color.
Oh, okay, sorry.
Oh, now we have...
Oopsie-daisies.
I thought we were putting those tokens in.
We took four of them. Okay. We don't want...
Perhaps if it's a color that doesn't correspond to a token, it's either a wild or it's a dud.
I think it's just a wild. Because there are not enough of the four color only. Okay.
Let's keep... Maybe we keep the middle of the strip. Blank or something.
What about our starting spots?
Oh yeah.
And then the starting spots. And then the ships will start here in the middle, I guess.
Cool.
Sure. There we go.
Okay, so we all go at the same time it seems, right? Each round?
We all put a card in.
Okay, I'll just kind of go around.
Does this only do for one half of the hotels, not fully across?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Sure. Don't, okay. Each one is for their respective side.
Before we start playing, don't we also have to have the objective? Right.
We need to know what we're collecting.
Right. We need to collect like.
So there needs to be four roll cards.
Yeah. Okay.
And in the actual game, this should be more than that.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Well,
so the alien has different requirements.
Right.
Every time.
Right.
Yep.
Yeah.
So it's like. Well, four of them are.
Four of them are people. One is.
Should we just use?
Yeah. Someone's the alien.
All right.
And in this case, the alien.
We have one alien card.
Got it.
And
four non-aliens.
These look like people.
Yep.
Sure.
Okay.
I'm just suspicious.
I don't look like a person.
No.
All right.
Okay. So someone's gonna be the alien.
Not the first
time. Secret.
Okay.
All right. Yeah.
All right. There's more than four cards in there. Oh, there's five of us.
There's five of us.
Math is hard.
Math.
I know.
Math. Can be hard.
I hope I'm the alien.
Maybe
I'll
just
I know you
both
here.
I hope I'm the alien.
Alright, okay. Everybody look, but don't, reveal any information.
Alright.
Woo!
Alright.
Woo!
Alright.
Okay. And then.
Okay, and so the alien is trying to get, let's just say, like, two reds and a blue.
Okay, just so we're going to write that real
purposes.
Big.
Yes.
I'm not going to. Okay.
This particular version of the alien wants two reds and a blue.
Right here. Boom.
Oops.
Later on in flavor version could mean
two reds
certain
and
things.
Do we want to have a turn limit on the game as well?
Ooh.
Yeah,
we have this on the board. I think that might actually.
Hey, we're incorporating pieces now. Great.
Yeah.
There you go.
Okay. What do you mean by the turn limit?
Like at some point the game's over.
Regardless.
Okay. Like if the alien doesn't get his job done at a certain time.
Okay, so I'm gonna put this
or
you put that in the middle.
If they don't find the person by that time, an alien invasion happens anyway.
Right. Maybe the alien just. Yeah.
Yeah. Like we have to find that person. Are we still serial killers? Is that still
the thing? Is if time happens,
who
loses?
Yeah, that's somebody loses.
We could just be
that's
ritualists.
Helpful. Ritualists.
What
yeah.
Oh, guys,
or
I have an idea.
Detectives.
We're humans, right? Mm-hmm. Except for one of y'all. If we're all looking for an alien, I'm sure the rest of the world doesn't believe in us because we're probably a.
There you go.
Sure. All right. So I think that ties into the ritual. Maybe we think we have some like special rock that gave us powers, or that kind of thing.
Well, I think maybe even just we are a part of some thing.
Right.
And like the way we out the alien is some ritual.
Mm-hmm.
At some point we have to make the call on who we think it is.
Right. Like some kind of exorcism or something.
Yeah. Should there be
and if you exercise the wrong person, that's really not good.
Right.
Yep. So
they get
shamed
in our count.
Maybe
shamed.
We can have a certain amount of wrong rituals, because ritual cards eventually will have to be played.
Right.
So you want to play it to accuse somebody.
Right. That, okay,
I see what
I like
you're
that.
Yeah.
Instead
I
of turn
like
limit,
that.
It's like if we try to accuse someone, we may fail. We may not even fully accuse the person.
And we have to do something like maybe a puzzle or something. If we don't complete that ritual, we can't accuse the person. It counts as a failed ritual. If we do succeed and don't and find somebody that isn't the alien, it's also a failed ritual.
So what if let's talk about the ritual for a second, because I feel like the ritual is really important given that's the theme.
That's the theme.
Yes.
When a ritual happens,
right.
And we're like, hey, let's convict someone of being an alien and out them and skew them. What if all of these cards had numbers on them?
Okay.
And so those
like
numbers,
1, 2, 3, 4.
Essentially when we're like, okay, reveal happens, and the turn structure is still a little fuzzy, but reveal happens, and it's like, hey, we think Zach's the alien, because he wants to be the alien. Obviously, he's the alien. So then, based on, at that point, whatever card you have left in your hand, we each get to put a card into the book.
Okay.
And there's some number, based on whatever numbers end up on here,
right.
that have to get past that for us to officially accuse the person.
Okay.
And so, like, if I don't think I'm the alien, I'll put a 1 in. Because it's like I'm trying to make the number low.
Good.
Does that make sense?
Okay.
So you're voting with the number you put in. If you think it's the person, it's like I'll put my 4 in.
Right.
Because I'm trying to make that number really high.
Right. Okay. But should they all be the same? Like move is 1, stay is 2, solve is 3, ritual is 4.
Well, it could go either way. Because if they're different, then like I may hold a 4 stay just because it's a 4.
Oh yeah,
and I think I know that you're the alien. Okay. So right. When it comes time, I want to have the 4, not you.
I was thinking that if you really want to accuse somebody, your hand will be forced to play a certain card that you might not get back.
Somebody was asking, how do we get Gabby in the shark costume? $25 to spin the wheel. It's
and then
a
you
possibility.
Land on the
$50 to pick the wedge in the wheel. Just saying.
Give me just 1 second. So I think
this randomly number of things 1 through 4.
I think it could go either way.
Or should they all be the same? Like move is always 4.
I think it's more interesting if they're different.
Okay,
because
so
if I get the 4,
so
I could have 3 of the 4s.
Yeah.
And
so
I could keep playing the non.
Well, should we have? Hold on. Should we have them all be different? All the moves
like all the
are
moves
1 through 4.
Like,
all the solves are 1 through 4.
Yeah.
So
everybody.
Do we all have one of each right now?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
So you're 1, 2,
well, she's already
4.
Yeah.
Well, what did you number yours?
Well, my ritual is 1.
Okay, all right. Let's do 2 here.
Yeah.
So I'll give you all blanks so you can put 1s on the rest of your cards.
You're just going to number all of yours 1.
Yes, keep your ritual 1.
We're just trying to get
a
number.
Oh, I understand. So who's the 2 group?
So you're 2,
I'm
so
two.
Take
that's
your move out.
That's the 3 group.
The 3, got it. Okay, I'm 4.
And then that's the 4 group.
You need the song.
Beautiful.
Yep. I don't have all the cards. I have 2 cards.
Do you need a move?
I need a stay.
Oh.
Yeah, I might need
one. Oh, here's
one
the
more.
Stay.
I need a stay, and then move,
I
stay,
have
ritual.
Two
solve.
I
need
two
a solve,
a
blank
here's
solve.
A
there we go.
Perfect.
I have one of everything.
All right, and then I'm
you're 5.
I'm 5.
Okay, so the average there, 5, 9. We probably need, like, 11 to officially convict.
Okay,
okay.
To officially...
To say, yeah,
start
we think this
ritual
is who it is.
To kind of send the alien back to its home planet and save the world.
Yep. So we should randomly, since we all have different handwriting again, randomly deal out the moves, stays, solves, and flips.
Well, I don't think we have to have a full suite of everything. We can just pile these all up now and shuffle them.
Oh, that makes sense.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sure.
And then,
okay.
Yeah, we might not.
You might not even have certain actions.
Sure.
Okay,
sure.
Cool.
So then there's a one thing now that I'm slightly want to ask a question about, which is we all put a card in to do a thing. How does the turn go at that point?
Right, so I think this is where like the role playing is useful, where like we can just, let's say to win the game you do this, and I'll just do that. Do you have a suggestion?
Potentially.
Okay.
I think there's a lot of ways the turn structure could go. What if, so you have them shuffle them up, and it's like reveal the top one.
Mm-hmm.
We all take that action.
Okay.
Yeah.
Then you reveal the next one, we all take that action.
Okay.
So there will be an accuse.
All
we
right.
all have to accuse someone.
Right. That is the ritual card?
Ritual, yes.
Okay.
There's a ritual, we all, like, so when it's ritual, you start, and you're like, I think it's so-and-so.
Right.
And then you can choose to put a card
5?
In or not.
I have 5.
All right, give.
There's 1 back.
1 back, 4.
Okay.
There we go.
Is me?
Yep.
So do we all put down a card?
So start of the turn.
Okay.
Blanks. Oh, who's who?
I'll be blue, because.
Oh, wait, we need a 5th.
Oh,
we need
a 5th.
Oh, giggle.
Do we have another?
I'll sit out.
Yep.
I'll sit out this round.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. So, take a card.
Well,
this
doesn't matter anymore since we have the cards. So these
right.
pieces could be anything now.
Yeah, it could literally be.
So, here, let's just.
Make it the X-Wing.
But, why don't we. I mean, they could all be the same thing.
All the same thing.
Yeah, all the same thing, but just a different. Like.
What about.
Here, we could just write numbers on the brains.
Yeah, just there's not enough.
Yeah, we got brains. We're gonna number the brains.
Yeah, let's just number the brains.
Yeah, that's better.
Either way, just number a token.
Well,
here,
okay.
We can do this because it's easy to write on.
Oh
yeah,
yeah.
Those are easy.
Sure.
Yeah.
Okay,
credits.
So, layer 1. Layer 2. 5. 6.
5.
I want to do all of them. All right.
Cool.
So these are gone.
Too late.
So
you want someone
I'm
to start in the
1,
middle?
2,
yeah,
3,
someone
4,
will start.
5. Okay.
Someone will start in the middle. So.
Middle
player
three.
5 starts in the middle of this. I guess we can randomly determine.
We'll just do 1.
This in the future.
Oh, sure. 1
yeah.
down line.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Makes sense.
Yep.
Yeah.
And then
okay.
I guess you can start.
So, somebody says,
stuff.
I feel like Ian should have to dance. Not everyone.
Just Ian.
I agree.
And I have a feeling that I know who that is.
Perhaps the dance can be added to the game again. Wink.
Alright, so we all put a card in.
Okay.
This is him.
Alright, so we're all putting it right here.
Yeah. Okay. And is when we move within our area or move to another building?
We're gonna figure that out.
Alright.
Okay. Okay, so we all put a card in.
Okay. Alright, and then one person shuffles them up.
These get shuffled. Okay.
Okay.
So we don't know who voted for what, right? That's fine.
And most of us are looking for an alien so that
all
we can ritual.
So we can ritual. Yeah.
And then right. One of us.
Or we're looking to get eight pieces.
Yep.
Yeah, right.
So, right. Move. Okay. I think everyone should have to pick a move.
Yeah.
Okay. So starting with player one.
Sure.
You'll be initiative, so you start with initiative.
So what do we move?
So
spaces?
How do we want move to happen?
Yeah.
A dice roll,
and then
die roll,
whatever adjacent.
Singular.
No diagonals.
It costs two yeah. to move to an adjacent building.
Across the street.
Across the street. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, so I'm. All right, I rolled a five.
Yep. So you can move anywhere within your space.
Okay.
Number one.
Oh, are we gonna move
three,
that player?
Or...
Yeah.
Oh, okay, I see.
I'm moving my
yeah,
stuff,
you're
right?
Player one.
I see.
So whatever action you put into the stack, everyone's gonna get a D1.
No, I know, but she rolled a five, so she moved player five, or?
No.
I don't know, you move player one.
No,
player one.
That's right, I'm sorry.
Yep.
I'm player one, I'm gonna move five. So do I want to get closer to another person because they're possibly an alien?
If you want to accuse somebody, I think you need to be in the same building.
Okay,
but.
Sure. Right.
How about just adjacent tile?
I think yeah.
Adjacent tile might be too hard. I think I think building. We can see how it works.
Because like an alien could go off in the corner, but that can make him look like an alien.
So what's motivating my moves right now?
Right now we're as players, we're just trying to capture
two of everything, right?
Eight.
Okay, so it doesn't matter. Okay, I'm gonna move
two of each color.
One, two, three, four, five.
Yep.
Okay.
So that's your move.
I'm gonna reveal this, or
oh, we have to wait till we have a.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, time! Uh-oh.
Oh.
Do it for the children. Gabby Lone Shark.
I think we're spinning the wheel.
I think it's wheel time.
All right.
Yeah.
All right.
Take a break from our game. There's another awesome game. I would probably be. Shark.
We already got Dan, but I think we should spend it again. Do you want to spend it?
Yeah.
Go ahead.
I think it's a
we
sharky
don't have the
costume.
Time.
It's a sharky costume.
Do you have
does
that?
It? Yeah.
Yeah, it
yeah.
totally
yeah.
says that.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, I couldn't tell from my angle, the arrow.
Yeah, there was a little bit of glare.
Yeah, that's fair.
Optical
yeah.
illusion
all right, could somebody down in the engine room bring the shark costume to the bridge?
Fantastic.
Thank you.
I don't think I need these now.
Oh, I'll take them.
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah. Well, some other people aren't wearing bunny ears.
So I'm actually a little okay with the you were saying earlier.
You move
when you move, whenever you land on a piece, you just reveal it.
Okay,
great.
So
eventually, it'll make it go faster.
Just like
it's magic.
Shark attack!
Shark attack!
Shark attack!
All right, so now we know that this space is a green space, but you have to roll a six to get it. Is that the?
There it is. Now you also know the difficulty.
Yep. Yeah.
Which is cool.
So we remove this from the game board.
Okay. So you move. Now the shark.
So do we collect?
Well, now you now
we remove the piece. Yep. We know it's green, but now we know we have to roll six to get it.
Yep.
Oh.
Oh, cool.
Okay. But when do we roll?
Oh my god.
When you get a salt.
A salt.
Shark.
Yeah.
Woo!
Pizza delivered. All right. So now we reveal the next card, correct? We reveal all the cards that we all put in?
Well, do you want every player to have to move? Or,
oh, that's right.
Or it could be first player has to do this. Second player has to do the second card. Third player has to do the third card.
I think everyone does all actions.
Everyone does all actions?
Really like
okay,
everybody.
So
you move. Sharky move.
Sharky
someone
move.
Someone flip that for me?
No, you move.
I move.
Yep, so you're number two.
Well, this is going to be a disaster.
Where would you like
I got to roll a die.
Okay, roll a die.
I got
two.
Where do you want
to go? I would like to go.
There.
Yeah.
So we can go diagonal. We're gonna make diagonals a thing.
Oh, diagonals.
All right. So another green.
Green.
Wait. Do I get to flip it?
Also on a six.
When you stop a movement, you reveal.
When I stop a movement.
Yep.
But you don't solve it. All right. You can move.
Sweet. Somebody just reminded me.
Flip the timer.
Yeah.
Okay. We got.
Oh, we get two of those.
Yeah.
Yeah. A little less than so much time. Yeah.
We're literally in swimming in time.
You're five. Oh no, you're three.
Triss.
Yeah. You're five.
I think this many.
Sure. Bam, flip it, gold, yellow. Yellow.
All right.
Thanks for reminding me.
I move number four.
Look at all those sharks.
Let's roll a two.
It's like a shark party.
Let's go pew pew. It is purple, which is known as blue.
Purple with blue in this case?
Yeah, it's not actual blue.
All right. So I think the numbers are all the same on this board, so we might just.
Numbers?
Yeah, I think six is always in the corner. No, that's not true. Never mind.
That's not true at all.
Ignore me. Like you normally do.
You are officially ignored.
Five.
Okay, you got a five.
All the moves.
Yep. I'm gonna jump buildings here. So one, two, three, four, five.
That is a yellow. There might be an alien. Get ready to do your
ritual. Alright, so we all did the move.
Okay. Yep. Mm-hmm.
Now.
Next card.
We all do the ritual.
Okay.
So the way the ritual works is, we'll start with you, Stella. You're the first player for this whole round.
Right.
You can choose a player that you think is the alien. And then we all get to vote with the cards in our hand. And if the total number is over an 11, we're actually going to accuse that person. And then it's potentially game over. And you don't have to put a card in.
Yep. Okay. So if the ritual, is it the player whose number was on the ritual accuses? Or do we all accuse? Do we want to have five accusations in a turn?
Yeah, it's a little heavy.
Yeah. Do we have a rotating first player?
We all move.
Why not have it be unanimous? Everyone agrees, three to whatever, that this specific person we're going to accuse.
And what if we can't get unanimous?
Then
we fail the ritual?
Just fail the ritual.
What if on a ritual it's just the first player chooses a person? Male vote.
We have a rotating cult leader.
Yeah, I think every time a ritual happens, it goes to the next person.
Okay. And they can choose to accuse
And that can
or
be
not,
the X-Wing
or...
is the rotating cult leader.
Oh, no, because we're putting
in
cards.
Got it.
Yep. Okay.
So, as leader of this cult, I accuse Ian. I think you're trying to abduct people's brains.
Dang.
And we need to start the ritual to send him back into space.
Okay.
Is that the ritual
to send them back into space?
Yeah, I'm down. Yep.
So a rocket propelled.
Yeah. All right. So we need to get back.
So how do we vote?
Over 11?
Over 11. So you put a card in, and it has a value on it.
Okay.
And we're going to total, and if it's over 11.
And what happens if we fail the ritual? What happens if we succeed?
Then we reveal your card, and if you're an alien.
Okay. If we fail, we reveal my card, I'm not the alien.
If we pass 11, we reveal your card, if you're not the alien. The players lose the alien ones.
Okay, so accusing someone early on could just end the game.
But we also have to still get past 11.
Yes.
So right now voting with a high number is like
is
really risky.
Yes. Unless you're really
unless you're the alien.
Yes.
Then it's like I'll put the five in.
Oh yeah.
Because like I want the game to end. That's not me.
Okay.
All right. One.
One. Six.
Six.
Ooh.
10.
Ooh.
Did we lose?
14. Yeah. Whoa! All the fours. Alright, so you're revealing.
Test run.
Let's see if you're the alien.
I'm not the alien.
We killed Gumshoe.
Gumshoe.
We just burned an innocent person. So,
so the number now needs to be
higher.
What
does dead man ever die?
Yeah.
At minimum.
Yep. Okay.
Okay.
So, well, I think when you guys put your cards in.
I only had fours.
Oh, did you? So, yeah, perhaps the number needs to be higher.
I went for a high number because I just wanted to see what happened. Okay, I'll start.
I just have high numbers, sorry.
Do you guys want to undo what just happened?
Absolutely not.
No.
So what happens when someone is burned at the stake and is out?
Right.
Well, they become another alien.
I think they're an alien.
They're a revealed alien.
Yeah.
They're so mad.
We get a ritual and it turns them into an alien.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Crap. So now we have two aliens.
Now you have two people. Yeah.
And now we just know he's the dude. And he's not the one we're looking for.
Right.
Okay. But I'm also trying to make everybody lose.
You're trying to make this happen.
Yep.
Okay. And we don't want you to be able to let that happen.
Yes. So if I reveal reds and blues, you want to come to the building I'm in and take those from me before I get them.
Yeah, I like that a lot.
And then
a failed ritual doesn't cost you the game, it just makes it harder
for the player's
players.
Right.
Okay.
Sorry if it's hot in there.
But really,
warm,
really quickly,
but
it could be a player against four aliens.
I'm usually cold.
And he could win against the four, which is funny.
Does that.
No, I'm not. It's the same way that one alien could win.
Yeah, no, I'm saying, does that sound good to everybody?
So this is the way that alien can win.
Yep,
right?
So now.
Is that the way that we can win too? I'm just trying to clarify.
We win by getting eight.
Oh, okay. We get eight.
Usually, you get eight of
anything.
Anything.
Perfect.
And the alien needs to get that. And now that I am a brainwashed alien, Okay. I'm brainwashed by the ritual to help the aliens. I also need to get that. So you want to stop me from getting two blues, two reds and a blue.
Okay.
But okay.
The aliens combined.
Right. Yeah, we're making it easier and easier.
Oh,
yeah.
You to just yes.
It's picking
okay.
it up, right? It's
yeah.
not just
so
flipping
in
it.
Early
yeah,
days,
it's
so maybe you don't want to vote to ritual people to ritual a person.
Yeah,
yeah.
yeah.
Until
strategy.
Someone's being suspicious.
Yeah. Okay.
Early on, it's what you're
yeah.
just potentially
yep.
really hurting yourself.
Right. You're just changing everybody yeah. into aliens.
Okay, so we did the ritual.
Okay.
Right. Now
okay.
we do the next thing. Which is solve. So we each get a solve action, starting with the
okay.
leader.
So I already flip that. So what do you get
so
to do? Pick
when
an
you
adjacent.
Solve, I think you roll for the
okay.
space you're on or an adjacent space.
I think you should roll two dice.
Okay.
Yeah.
I think solve should be kind of easy.
Yeah.
All right. Roll two
but
dice
still,
and
still failable. All
yeah.
right. I got.
So you
ooh,
did fail.
I
yep.
got a double four.
Yeah.
Double
two is just four. Two. So you didn't get the six.
All right.
So number two.
Okay. I got this. I got a 6, 8.
You
eight.
Got it.
Very nice.
You collected
a green. Thanks to Uncle's Games for resubscribing to this channel for 4 months in a row. Just a reminder, this is Grab Bag, a board game where we take guest developers to make a board game from board games. My name is Malika. This is
Gabby
from Lone Shark.
Nathan, University
from
of Washington.
Awesome.
Zach from Team Cover.
Ian, I work for Asmodee.
And so far, we all are people trying to find aliens. And we can do this special ritual to send them back into space. Unfortunately, we found a regular person and now they are.
Perform the ritual and they have
yeah.
now turned aliens.
I'm now brainwashed to help the aliens.
Exactly.
Because that's how
exactly.
aliens were created.
That's how
yes.
they were created in the long time.
I think
time.
This is becoming like a statement on like prejudice and,
sure. yeah, it's
and xenophobia.
Deep theme.
Yeah.
Exactly,
yeah.
yes.
Well,
yeah.
About
this is
Blizzardtopia
games.
So, okay. So you solve.
What a great
move. Congratulations to you. You get a solve. Bob.
Three.
Yeah, right. Three.
Two.
You
got
two.
It. Excellent.
Yeah, let's
yep.
do it.
All right. So.
And then
I get a solve. Where am I? What am I at? Four. I need a six. Four. More at one.
All right. Can you choose not to solve, not to roll? Because now that I am a revealed alien,
why
I don't want to help people.
Well, it
no,
that counts to the alien total, not towards
I think we
ours.
Well, but I don't need a yellow. I guess you're right.
You just want to take it off the board.
I see.
Right,
so
no, we can't get it.
Oh, I see.
And now we
so
still have to flip over to even be able to.
Okay, so revealed aliens and brainwashed people
are on the same
remove
game.
It from the board.
Right,
got
they
it.
Don't put it in the pot.
If it's a token that's not part of the ones
yeah.
they're collecting, they just eliminate
it
from the game.
I mean, it could even just go to their collection, but they don't care. They don't need it.
Yeah.
It's just
but it, whatever it is, it doesn't count towards the
yeah,
player's collection. 100%.
All right, so we solved. Now the next thing. Ritual.
Ritual.
Damn.
Woo.
All right. One in what? 25.
All right. So leader, you get to choose again.
One
still
in
four.
We talked about shifting the number higher. Are we doing that, or for now keeping it at 11?
Let's try to go.
I think
one
of them.
12.
I think like
13.
15.
You think?
Because there's
so many.
It needs to be scaled on
the
number of players. It needs to be like three times the number of players.
Sure.
Yeah. Okay.
Sure.
Okay.
15
yeah.
sounds good.
15.
Also, we forgot to give everybody a card back after the last
oh.
ritual.
Okay.
Shuffle them back up, you'll get a card back.
Oh, so we have more votes, yeah.
Okay.
After a ritual, we get a card back.
Okay.
So who are we accusing?
Yeah, who are you accusing?
Why
me.
Is it always on me?
Because
you're still
we're still in the first
turn.
Oh,
that's
the
stack.
First.
Okay.
Fearless leader. Where are you burning now?
Poor guy.
It's not
we already know it's him. You. You with the lemur shirt. You gotta be an alien. You have no sense
right.
of Earth fashion sense.
And
damn.
Now, do you get a vote?
I would say no, because I'm a revealed person. Or
so the number of legal players left times three is the number we're
I think, you should be a royal.
Yeah, I can vote.
Here's a suggestion from the chat
poison
room.
Pill.
The weird thing is if you have a five, you can just drop it in, right?
I know,
yeah.
right?
The traitor should be able to take mission tokens off the board to prolong their survival. Yeah, I think that's what we decided
totally.
On.
Yeah.
Because like if you have like two alien, known aliens,
yeah.
they just both put a five in, you're...
What about if there's a revealed alien, they don't put a card in, but it reduces the difficulty by their three or whatever.
That's what I was saying.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
Okay. So now the difficulty is times three.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah. All right. Now the difficulty is 12. That makes sense.
Yeah. So yep. Now
are we writing these details down? I feel like we're gonna forget them.
Well, it's the internet. So is somebody gonna watch?
That's true.
And let us know if we mess up.
I vote.
So we're trying to get past 12. Let's shuffle them up so we don't make it better.
Okay.
Mine's gonna be the one, just by the way.
Three.
Four.
Eight.
Eight.
Nine. No one does.
Oh.
All right. So we all voted. Now I'm gonna shuffle these that we voted with back.
Okay.
And who was accused?
Back to the people that voted.
Score one for the humans.
All right. So
that's the end of the ritual.
Last card.
Stay.
Okay.
Stay.
And what is?
Stay lets you reveal an adjacent.
Okay. So are we all going to get to reveal
without
one?
Without having to move, yeah. Sure. So okay. Starting with you, because you're a leader still.
Am I showing other people, or is
you just turn a tile over that you're adjacent to?
Okay. This
do,
one?
Do you peek or reveal it to the
Flip it over.
Flip it
just
over,
flip
okay.
Flip it over? All right, I'm going to flip this over. There's nothing here.
It's like, what color is it?
Green.
So the green goes, all right. And then this goes away.
Yep. So that doesn't matter.
Now we know it's a green three.
Because we need blue and red. Sure. Get rid of the aliens.
But we need eight to win as well.
Just that's true.
Shark.
The far away one, yeah. Thank
yellow.
You. Still not having the aliens.
We actually like the non-red blues.
Yeah.
As players. Because they need to reveal those to
that.
Yeah.
And then this is red.
It's red.
Yeah.
Alright, cool.
Alright, and then. Wait, I'm number four.
Yeah,
you did three.
Four.
Yeah, you're number four. Yeah.
Oh, okay. I thought you just did that one. Let's do this one.
Was that the
wild? I will do not red or blue. Stay green, yellow.
Good, stay covert alien buddy.
Right.
Sneaky this
alien.
One.
But
me, red.
If I was the alien, maybe I would reveal it at this point.
Sure.
Oh man.
No.
Okay. So we went through a whole turn.
Yep.
These get shuffled out.
Dealt out.
Yep.
You pass the first player token. Leader token to the shark.
Zoom.
So now she's the first player.
Okay.
Very nice.
Pew, 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 pew. So
if it's the end.
Laser or shark.
Because we're done with stack.
Yeah.
So this is you.
That's my file.
This is yours. This is yours. And this is mine. All right. So now we will all choose a maneuver to put into the pile. And now there's a game happening.
Yes.
Because now you're choosing a move that you want to happen.
Right. Exactly.
Okay.
Progress.
This is surprisingly healthy, so.
Yeah.
Right. What?
It's surprisingly a good. Like,
yeah. Surprising.
On the drive here, I was like, man, I hope we can put a traitor mechanic in the game.
Traitor!
We did it. All right.
Spoilers.
Even though you weren't the alien, you
the first one is a three move, which is important to remember.
Okay. Okay.
Three moves a gauntlet.
Yep.
All
right, so you have to roll. Three?
Everyone
so
rolls.
You starting with you.
So.
Oh, right, me.
You roll.
And I think we still start with player one, two, three, four, five. Right?
Yeah, I mean, if we're all always doing it, it doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter the order.
Right. Well, it could matter.
Well,
oh, you're right. It
does matter.
Yeah,
it
will
matter.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think I like it.
Because the alien's going to
try
once.
That makes sense.
She's still token one on the board.
All right.
It could be like player, star, circle.
Sure.
Yeah.
Rolling one.
Square, triangle.
I got to move one.
Very nice.
I gabbied that roll so hard. That's what they call it at the office when I roll, because it's always one
number
and
two. Can
I
help you out?
Yes, please.
Where are you going, Sharky?
I'd like to go one that way.
This way?
Yep.
So you land, and it flips us over?
Tunes. I don't know if you know who that is. Already imagining
which is wild
how other loan sharks would look in the shark
wild.
Costume.
Let's do green.
Not nearly as
green.
Good.
So green goes here?
Yeah, I'm the best shark.
Yeah.
Okay.
No
and
offense
you get
to
move?
My compadres.
So roll a die.
Shark suit is so me.
Three.
And I'm here.
Somebody said we got
so who's
shark
four?
Size.
This is the alien guy.
Whoa.
One,
what is that
two,
about?
Three.
It's interesting though, because like I want to go pick up the red because I'm a good guy, right? I'm a non-alien.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But that can make me look like the alien, because which is what you want out of the old trader mechanic.
Yep.
Is it my turn? Sorry.
Where you can go for that red, man.
I'm definitely going to.
Nope.
Can I
nope.
Move here?
You,
I'll move here. Flip it. It's wild.
Okay.
I'm going to make it red.
Ooh.
So we
nice.
Should we should
aliens.
Make sure.
Aliens.
Does that make me an alien or not an alien?
I don't know.
We're alien buddies. Six. One, two, three. One, two, three. I can't do it, can I?
You want to run one, two?
Can you
never
can you move back? into a space that you moved across?
No backsies.
No backsies?
No, you should.
Puzzle
yeah.
it out.
You should be able to go back, I think.
Oh, so
oh if it's empty,
spot.
Yes. I meant no backsies as in, like, you can't just be like,
also,
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
About the old TIE Fighter Patrol.
Yeah, we didn't move them.
Oh,
we
yeah.
should have done that at the end of the last round,
yeah.
probably.
So the...
You know what? I think we could just use them to denote the aliens that are known.
Sure.
Okay,
sure.
Do that?
Instead of the brain tokens?
Yeah.
It's just a lot to keep track of.
All right.
But yeah. we don't have nearly as many TIE Fighters as we do
brain
possible
tokens.
Possible aliens?
That's
true. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, we have to buy more X-Wing cert packs.
Well, there we
oh,
go.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
There you go. To play
but
this
I mean,
game.
Like, support
we,
your local
we,
games. Someone's right? an alien, and then
we did just start
aliens.
This round when we flip one card. Yeah. And it won't really affect anybody because you moved from down here.
Sure.
I mean, from up there. But they just move one. Up and down, right?
Yeah.
And then
sure.
they go to the back and they
yeah,
keep
yeah.
doing that.
Oh, you know what?
So
they
now
can,
you
they
can't.
They can actually just even loop around.
Oh, yeah. They could just
oh, yeah.
do that.
It's like Max the
Circle.
And was it you can't reveal or you can't.
You,
I can't abduct
can't
that
take,
person.
You can't take
you can't
right?
that person.
Yes.
Yeah.
So
which
that,
is
that
interesting.
Helps. Yes. So
right.
six.
I like that.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
And no takesy backsies.
No takesy backsies. Okay. That's a yellow.
Okay.
That's boring. Boring to me. Alright.
Yellow is so good. Alright, we moved. Now, back to the leader.
Okay. Oh, I didn't move.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
So I have to roll,
TIE
right?
Fighter.
Yep.
The TIE Fighter.
I have a one.
One.
Okay, well, I'm just gonna go here. Do I flip it?
Yep.
Okay. That's purple?
That's
red.
The red.
Oh, that's red. The red.
No, purple's blue, right?
I thought purple
there's
a, was
There's
oh.
actually red out there.
Oh,
yeah.
right. There's
like, this,
a,
this is the red one.
Yeah, that's
there.
The blue.
Okay, so it's
oh,
purple.
We
thing
messed one of them up.
That's right.
It doesn't matter. Just keep going.
Right. And so you moved.
Nobody
there, right?
saw it.
Right.
Nobody saw it.
No, but I don't take yeah. it.
You don't
no.
take it. All right. So you do
next now
okay.
I start.
Now the next.
Solve.
Dice.
Yep.
Solve.
So you get to roll through dice and attempt yep. to take you something adjacent to. Number two.
Saint Escape was asking how is the X-Wing miniatures game being incorporated. They are patrolling the board.
TIE Fighter Patrol.
So yep. as the players
it?
Are trying
seven.
To
I don't know what
collect
I
the tokens
six or less.
For
yeah,
their
yeah.
objective, they can block off a row, a column?
Yeah, a whole row or column, wherever they're adjacent to. So this red can't be taken right now.
Right, okay.
Right. Yep.
All right, so she solved, you're solved?
I solved.
Okay.
I'm getting
suspicious
yeah, of this
what
show.
Is... This one's six, I need six.
I wish you had said that louder, because that was a really funny joke. Huh?
Seven.
You did it.
Okay. Take that, you dirty alien.
Smells like an alien.
Yeah, huh? Okay. Because I, like,
so,
sniped the one you wanted.
So, me, where's another... This? What do I need?
Five?
Five.
I got
six.
It. I have a red.
A red, uh-oh. And
you
I
just collected one.
I could get another useless yellow. And I do.
So you just have to roll two or higher, right?
Yeah, for mine I did.
Right.
Yep.
Yeah.
So
we'll
some are easier.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I need a five.
What, your number one?
Yeah,
yeah.
I'm number one.
You
can
take
to collect
the blue. Dice or roll two dice and then just
and
using
one
of them.
One of them is beating it?
Yeah.
I like that
one
better.
Totally.
That's yeah. better. I like
it makes
yeah.
it a little harder.
A little
yeah,
harder,
okay.
yeah.
So I got a six and a five,
yeah,
so I can take that.
Yeah.
Yep.
And we are gonna beat the aliens.
Well,
that's
your personal
your
one, because you could
yeah.
still be an alien. That
right.
could still be your objective.
Oh yeah,
like, I got
totally
the red, so
I
could be the alien.
And
you
like,
could also
like
be
someone
alien.
Might get turned
yep.
into an alien.
We
right.
all
too.
Might be the alien.
That's true. Getting
yeah.
turned
yeah.
into
an alien
least...
would be bad.
I did draw a bunch of alien cards.
That's true. Yeah.
Man, that's really brutal. Because like, if I have a blue, I could look like the alien. You accuse me, and I'm not. But now those tokens count for the aliens.
Right.
Yep.
Ouch.
So, Ian, not to butt in, but I heard you do this thing called organized play?
Yeah,
because we have viewers from all over the world in our chat room.
Well, if you would like to participate in organized play for...
What is it?
What is organized play?
Yeah.
It is play that is organized. No, what we tend to do for organized play for the Asmodee games, Fantasy Flight games, and Days of Wonder Asmodee play... Is we want to incorporate retailers, brick and mortar stores to build their player communities. And so we give them the tools and prize support that they need to run tournaments or events. We run
like
events at Gen Con,
right?
like Netrunner. Netrunner has a vibrant organized play. X-Wing is another game that we're featuring here. in this game that we're making has a lot of players. These are great games, and so we work with the retailers to kind of help promote these games through marketing and
awesome.
Get more people to play them, really, and it's a lot of fun to do that.
So if I think that's great, and I own a board gaming store, what do I do?
Alright, I didn't think I'd be working today.
Oh, well, excuse me, let's get back to designing a game.
So, go talk to your local retailer, awesome. Ask them about organized play, and they can contact their sales rep or their distributor and have any questions answered for them.
Thank you, that was cool. Where were we? I just took the blue.
That's it. Yep. So we're back to card deal leader.
I'm on vacation.
Solve again.
More solve. More
We could
solve.
Lose it all right now if we're humans. There's a red
if
on the board.
Humans,
if
shark.
We're humans.
Shark. There's blood in these waters.
Go for it.
All right. I'm number two.
You can get the red or the yellow.
I can get the red or the yellow. I'm gonna go.
So you have to roll.
Do I have to declare what I'm doing?
You have to choose.
I'm gonna go for the red for the sake of the humans, because I'm really afraid that an alien might, you know, snipe that.
So solve is you can pick up anything. I thought solve was flip.
Oh wait,
adjacent.
Actually, hold on.
Solve is flip and adjacent. I thought, right?
No.
Oh.
That is. What is that? Hold on.
Oh, that's stay investigate.
Right.
I don't have one of those cards in my hand. Yeah. I do.
Hold on. You actually can't do this one. Then.
No, because it's across
because
the street.
Because it's being in patrol.
It's being. Well, then I guess I'll get that yellow one.
Being patrolled.
Thanks, Tunes.
I got five.
You did it.
Yay!
All right. So right now there are we count as players, and we have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 pieces.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
So one more, and we're out of here.
Okay.
That's right.
Perhaps it should be like it's you need three to accuse.
Need...
It should be two per player. So instead of 8, 10.
Okay.
Because the scene is going to
okay.
Yep.
Yeah.
Things are spoken like a true alien.
Yeah. Well,
which
I am an alien.
You are.
Yes.
Yeah.
Because then
I like the pacing of this game though.
Yeah.
I'm not sitting around doing nothing.
It's pretty quick. We're going along.
Okay.
Whose turn is it?
Mine, I think.
Go.
Yeah.
Go.
Let's see.
That's four.
Yeah. And then I am here.
Sniper.
I could take that, right? Yeah. Let's get that. Oh, yeah.
So when we're solving, we can take adjacent ones too, or just the ones that we're on.
It's
okay.
Adjacent.
So
four.
Yep.
I'm not adjacent to anything.
Nope, and I am not either.
So
we can't solve.
Okay. Next turn. And you get a solve.
Oh, yes.
If you want.
All
right.
Forgetting things.
Yeah.
So
you need
I don't. Ca-
choose the three.
Oh yeah. Okay. I can go diagonal. Right?
Yeah.
Woo!
Yeah. You got it.
Six.
Okay, I got a six.
So this is your.
Yeah.
Oh, wait. Are we doing the? It has to be the. Number?
Yeah,
I think we decided that it has to be four or two.
Right.
And when they roll this way. So if you want to get a six, one of the dice has to be a six.
It has to be exactly it?
Yeah. Or just rolling multiple dice gives you a better odds of getting
that.
Then
I didn't get that.
Okay.
I don't think.
Well,
I don't remember
you know
what I rolled.
We'll have time to play it again.
Yeah.
Let's
think,
do that on the
I
next.
That,
yep.
Okay. Yeah.
That balance is going to determine how many tokens we need.
So,
because you have to match up.
Yeah.
I think you need less tokens.
Yep.
It's going to be way harder to get the tokens.
Next play test.
Okay. Right. So does that mean as humans we need 10 now, right?
We need 10.
10 tokens total.
Yeah.
Okay.
But you did get that token.
So now we do have the 10?
No. B doesn't count.
Mine don't count.
So
right.
We have 3, 6, 7, 8, 9.
Okay,
yep.
We need one more.
So
we're
going back to the
round.
Thing.
Okay.
Stay.
Stay.
So now
so
you
that
can,
means we can just look.
That means you can flip one over.
Yep, flip one over near you.
Okay.
In your hotel.
Yep, has to be adjacent to you in your hotel.
That was a blue.
Well, yeah, so it's revealed blue.
Okay. Sharky?
I like to flip the faraway one, because otherwise
this
that...
one?
Yeah, otherwise the fighter will
green?
Get on the next round.
That's smart.
The X-Men.
Patrol?
Yeah,
okay.
Patrol.
Bloop. Wild card.
Maybe red?
No, we'll go green.
Blue?
Hello.
Okay.
Good try.
Smooth.
Good try.
My hotel.
Green for alien.
Yellow.
Man, didn't work the first time.
All right, let's see what this one is. Hey, blue.
Excellent. Row.
Okay, and then we'll go to the last card of this round, which is a ritual. All
right.
Ooh. It's like kind of a make or break moment.
It is
okay.
Kind of a make or break.
Who should I? I'm accusing now, right?
Yes.
Yeah, you're the.
Where do you know
new...
you're an alien?
Me?
No, him.
Yes.
I feel like. I'm not voting for you. I'm not voting for me. It's crazy.
You're the alien.
What a twist. twist. It's one of you two. But you... He's the one who wants to be the alien.
Yeah, I do.
I know.
He's
I
an feel alien like fetishist. You're
the
alien.
Team, who win the whole time?
Alright, so everyone but you votes.
So and that's our right. threshold is 12?
He kicked out of that
so
part.
So who are you kidding?
Sorry, bro. Me.
Yeah. Let's just sit here and boo. Throw chips.
The pile? Okay, I can vote. Yes.
So retrogradus.
Where's the pile?
Right there. Right there.
Ta-da.
Right. And then as a revealed alien, I will shuffle it up.
Because we can trust you.
Yep. No, I just want something to do,
not sneaking anything in.
I just
want
to be
yeah,
popular.
Fair. I like it. I like something to do.
Continue.
All right, so what's the number now?
It's 12, right?
Yeah. Is
it, yeah.
So 1, 5, 9.
Oh!
Close.
Did you get turned into a... Oh,
no.
Wait, we don't do anything.
No.
So
no,
we don't
nothing
know.
Happened. Yep.
Yeah.
All
right.
Nothing happens.
And so these also get shuffled in, because they're...
Yep, oh, those are the end of the turn. All right, great.
First player passes to you.
Yes!
And then everyone gets these cards dealt back.
And then yep. everyone gets two cards back.
Yep, so...
Revealed aliens don't vote for traitor, right? That's
yes,
correct.
Yes, they're the threshold for...
they're in cahoots.
Did I do it again?
I have two.
You didn't vote the last time, so you
that's right, that's right, thank you.
Less. Yeah.
They're in cahoots.
I have a lot of really good cards in my hand.
Ah, yeah, my head!
I'm lying.
Alright, so we all put in a card for
okay
the turn.
Okay, oh, action card.
Move the...
Oh, yeah, move
these. Yep, these go, yep.
Ah, oh, man, that makes that hotel useless.
Can
I put in a card? Who has to put in a card?
Not to let you all know what I'm picking. What's the one that lets you pick up a token? Is that stay?
Solve.
Solve.
Yeah.
Or you can put... Yeah.
Oh, these are like super garbage cards. Nice.
Yeah.
Garbage to an alien?
Just
yeah
in general.
Alright, did you put a card in?
I did put a card in.
We're missing a card. You're,
yeah,
you're the
kind of cleaning up our play space here.
Can you hand me that cup that's under the table, please?
That cup
who's the
yeah,
card?
I think the shark needs some water.
So you're the first player.
Thirsty shark.
It was
yeah,
Sharky,
I know,
I was doing it for her. I'll let you reveal the cards as we go.
Alright.
They're saying Ian has a
so first action
face
of this turn.
Okay.
Blammo.
Solve.
So anything around, you can't.
So I can't do that. And I don't have anything.
Yep. I also can't do anything. So Ian?
Then that's why I flip a nearby one?
No, no, that's
or
where you...
Oh, I can try and steal
flip
the adjacent
flip
one,
anymore,
right?
You can steal a... You get a token.
Across the street.
All right, so I need to get... Try and get that.
What?
Right?
Yeah, greater, at this point, greater than 3.
Yeah, greater than 3. Mm-hmm. Got it. Right. Boom. Aliens have a blue.
Yeah.
At least. And then whenever the victory condition is reached, the other alien can reveal themselves.
100%.
Right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right.
And then it's Team Alien win.
Right,
okay.
Is everybody in their
soul?
You
get a soul?
Yep.
Okay. So.
You roll two?
Yeah.
Which one are you trying to solve for?
Because this one is blocked by.
It is.
Yep,
so
you can't
okay
do that.
Okay, so that's the only one I could collect, right?
You got it.
All right, cool.
Do we move to that school?
We haven't.
Yeah, well, oh. I like that though. I like when you
okay
solve an adjacent, you move into it.
I do too. Those are the little joys that pop up. Sharky?
Yes. I am solving two dice.
Do the people have 10 now?
Thank you.
Does everybody have 10?
Oh.
3, 6, 9, 3.
But we, do
yep
we say 2 per? Like, do you need a second one for this to be legit?
I think it's just the total.
I think it's just
six,
the total.
7, 8, 9, 10.
So
I think
once we hit 10, we resolve all the way to the end.
And then the
turn
game is over.
And then the game is over.
Right.
And if
right
the
right
alien has been found, it's...
Right. That the aliens won.
So it doesn't really matter if I get this.
Unless you're the alien.
Unless I'm the alien.
Yeah.
But I can't get the red one anyway.
Number
did
two?
I get I
yeah,
yeah I didn't.
Get
I thought we were doing I had to match it.
That we were
next,
switch that
next
after,
round.
Yeah,
next,
yeah,
next
and
round.
That's
no,
gonna change
that
how many tokens we need. Okay?
Okay.
You get a soul? Oh, we don't get a soul.
Yeah.
So you get a soul. The next action?
Sweet.
Ooh, double trade.
Ritual.
So oh my god. And I get to choose.
Mm-hmm.
It's gonna be you.
Go ahead.
Yeah.
So I maybe vote or not.
Let's check it out.
Buddy right here.
Yeah, well maybe I want to join the aliens.
What number are you? You're 1?
Sure I am.
Where were you before you moved into that space?
I was right over here.
Yep. Yeah. So you went for the blue one.
Yeah.
So you want to do a high number so that the players win.
Okay. So we have the 4. I'll let you since you don't get to do anything.
Yay!
And then what number do we need?
Because I am a poor brainwashed person. Higher than 12, because my 3 that was normally...
Right.
Yeah.
5.
7.
10.
14.
Ooh, reveal who you are.
Let's see it.
Where's my...
This one's
mine.
She's
gamer.
She's not the
I'm an innocent gamer kid. Alright,
you could be
gamer.
An alien then.
So you become an alien.
Oh, great.
But that also means those tokens don't count towards the players.
Towards the player.
Do they count to
their
aliens?
Ourselves if we're humans?
And the aliens already have blue. The aliens
so
are
we
just
need
reds.
One more red.
Well, you need two reds.
Oh,
total.
Two reds total, yep.
Well, that was a blow to humanity.
But
Do we shuffle this up?
We do at the end of the turn.
At the end, or?
The votes go back.
Oh, the votes go back. I'm sorry.
Right.
I messed it up.
I'll let you handle that.
So there's now 3 aliens in this game.
And the game isn't going to end this turn.
No.
Nope.
Second ritual. Right.
I like that. Because I like playing games. I don't want to.
It's one of you 3.
That's true.
Well, that is
statistically speaking.
So we don't vote because we're revealed.
And
yes.
we need more than 9 for it to actually be a successful ritual.
See, which is easy to do by accident.
This sucks because the red would help the aliens, but the
like, if you pick her and you're wrong.
I am clearly a human, though.
Well,
says the shark!
The thing, though, right? So if you pick her and we reveal her and she's not the alien,
yeah.
Then one of us is the alien.
Right. Obviously, one of you is the alien.
Yeah.
It's obviously one of you two.
Oh, my God.
I am the most honest shark you've ever
I
met.
I do not like bluffing games.
I'm also
true,
so honest
I,
that
well,
I look
it's,
like
it's,
I'm lying.
Most,
and I'm
most
the
aliens
truth.
Don't like bluffing games.
That's true fact about aliens.
Potentially, yeah. It could be one of the things.
People are saying, and you get an alien, and you get an alien.
Everybody gets an alien!
I'm
love
seeing
Oprah.
Sharks on the chat, so...
Humans
I'm
totally have dorsal fins.
Right.
Touching my shark
She's
nose.
Picking the shark, let's vote.
And then what is this, 9? We need 9.
We need more than 9.
Yep, more than 9. There are 3 remaining votes.
Isn't it 3 times the number of people?
Yeah, but more than that number.
Oh, more than it.
And the QZ gets to
Well, it's 3 times the remaining.
So, okay, so the previous one we needed 13 instead of 12.
Yeah, yeah.
Got
yeah.
it.
Which
okay.
we got.
We got 14.
Yeah.
I can't believe you're
right
accusing
here.
Me.
Look at this shark. So innocent. So human. So human eating.
You're going to shuffle this up and reveal since you're the newest alien.
Reveal.
Among us.
Okay, we got.
Alien Overlord.
We have 1.
All right, that's.
Woo!
Not great.
But
in?
We have 4.
So 5.
Yeah.
And 5.
10.
So 10.
10.
So you reveal your ID.
So reveal your
so
ID.
You gotta reveal your ID.
Shark person.
Another crushing
I knew it! I knew it!
She was the shark!
It's the red!
So, nobody uses that much paprika.
So, I was assuming you were an innocent chef at Paris Las Vegas.
Yeah, and
right?
then I got eaten by a shark.
Yep.
So with the brain tokens, does our ritual just involve slicing open their heads to reveal whether
like
or not
Siler
they have an
style.
Alien brain
and that's why
or?
They turn into
yeah.
Alien.
So, well, maybe they don't get the foil hat or something, and then they're.
So now here's a really interesting just game mechanic happening here,
right.
which is we're down to 2 players, right?
Yep.
So we know who the alien is.
Presumably.
We have to.
Okay.
Because if I'm not the alien, I know you are. If you're not the alien, you know I am.
Yeah.
But if we get to a ritual, I have no way of beating 6 by myself.
Right.
Like, if I'm not the alien, I have no way of accusing you of alien.
Right.
Good. So that helps the players, though?
That doesn't help the players.
No, that hurts the players.
That hurts the players.
Because the players can't
get
rid of the...
That's, yeah, sorry. That's what I meant. That's
so,
actually because that penalizes the players for
actually,
having
you know
wrong rituals. Because it makes it as it gets harder and harder.
Yeah. You
yeah.
Can, you
but,
can
like, so,
look.
Like, at this moment... Well, it doesn't matter what we find out because
right.
we know. So I'm, wherever my card is, I'm not the alien.
Okay. I knew it!
but
totally fooled!
But it's,
okay.
I'm trying to figure out how you balance. It should be really
right.
hard for the player to win at this point because there's one of him.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
But at the same time, it needs to be possible for me to win.
Right.
Because at this point, there's no, he has 3 tokens.
Right.
I have 1.
It's mm-hmm. really rough to kill all our tokens. Maybe we kill half round down.
We the players, the humans, they already achieved 10, like around last round.
But then they got
well, we
turned
couldn't
to
we
had to go to the end
the
of the turn.
Right,
yeah.
right. So
I mean, the...
There's also this puzzle book that we have not incorporated into the game yet.
Maybe, when you get down to two players.
Solve a puzzle. Puzzle race!
No, okay. I think...
It's a puzzle race?
Hold right. on, when you get down to two players, like let's see if you can outwit. What I would like is the Sudoku.
Ooh. No, like we don't do race? That because Sudoku is not a great type of puzzle. I say as a super puzzle snob. Okay. So, okay, so there are some great Sudokus out there, but in general, Sudoku, do something better.
Well, you're from Lone Shark. Do you have a puzzle?
We like all games here at Hyper RPG.
Yes.
Yes. There are some great Sudokus, but in general, this book contains not a one. Do you want like an easy-ish puzzle?
I want something that we can race at, so I can.
I can quiz you on limericks.
I've won the bunny ears once.
On what?
There are limericks where you have to fill in the blank with palindromes.
Okay. And we each do it on like a timer.
Like radar.
Oh, there's also a couple trivia quizzes in here.
I would argue that I outwitted everybody, and that should be sufficient enough.
Yeah. I didn't have a high enough card to. Put it over. That's how
you know
it
would be cool.
You have to believe in the heart of the cards.
Because I do think you need some kind of advantage for having converted three people to aliens, right?
Yeah.
Which is, what if the puzzle was you four get to solve it?
Oh!
And I have to solve it by myself.
Oh, yeah.
And I have to basically outwit the hive mind that is the aliens.
Yeah. That is actually in some way.
I feel
great,
like it's super unfair that I'm an alien right now.
That's just how
for
it
you.
Well, that was
but
my strategy.
That's cool.
She's very modest.
That situation.
Well, I'm like, I helped write the book. It's kind of cheating for me to solve.
Yeah, I know. But like, you know what I mean? Where it's like some puzzle where the difficulty is easier because there's four people trying to solve it.
Sure.
But not so much easier that it's impossible for me to win by myself.
If someone wants to commit $50, we can do this blindfolded.
Ooh, oh, blindfold puzzles.
Oh my gosh.
Should we?
Do we have
a should it literally be you build a puzzle? Do we have a puzzle that we can build?
I can write a puzzle.
Well, we,
no,
need,
I mean,
we
like,
need to get the book involved.
Yeah, oh, that's right.
Yeah, we need to get the book involved.
Well, so there's like, I can't flip. Flipping bad.
Okay.
You know what page we're going to
forward or back?
Go this way.
Yes, this way.
Like
much?
One page
I'm
at
very
a time.
Excited.
Too much? Too much.
This, oh, back. No. One back.
They're stuck. Very
another
good.
One back.
All right.
One more.
Okay.
This one.
Okay.
Oh wait, no, this is the really hard one. I thought it was a different one. I'm sorry.
Thanks a lot. You're trying to sabotage these.
If anybody
aliens.
Is familiar with this book, if they have a suggestion for what puzzle we should do.
I don't understand these earth puzzles.
How do they work?
Like I've had an alien ritual called lobotomy, so
like
I don't understand anything anymore.
Yeah, right
way
yeah. Okay.
That's
a meta. This is nice. This one is weapons.
Okay, you
want to. Just murdery.
It's the aliens.
We can do that.
Okay.
There's also like a fill in the blank clues one that is like about bats.
Okay.
Which is totally related.
Sounds like you like the bats.
Page
one.
87, probably.
Page 87?
You don't know.
There are no page numbers. They are pages by cards and suits.
Oh, very nice.
There's a crypto list. That's probably
ace of spades, then, right? That's what.
Not quite right. This would work.
Okay.
It's weapons. Weapons are murdery. We're
how
murdering
do we split
aliens
this into
and people.
Yes.
Weapons of choice.
Okay.
How do we split this so that the puzzle is in two?
Two.
Well, because there are several different things to solve here. One person will have to then solve all of these, and then we could divvy it up amongst ourselves and solve.
Right.
So theoretically,
well, it's aliens versus
faster.
People,
yes.
right?
Yeah,
and,
okay.
And at this point, do you guys reveal yourself? So
I think once you get down to two people,
I think when you get down to two, you reveal.
Okay,
and then you
it's aliens. So get over there, alien.
Ha.
Okay. Versus non-alien. So we have this puzzle in front of us, and essentially, you're saying I have to solve this all by myself.
Yeah.
I have to come up with all the answers, and you guys get to do it as a group. So technically, it's like you could have. Her working on these, her working on these, him working on him, and so on.
Yeah.
And I have to like scramble to get all of them.
Right.
And how does this puzzle work?
So the way this puzzle works.
And you don't get to play.
And I won't play.
Should we do? Can we do a dramatic reading of the flavor text?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Very, very
would
nice.
You like to do it?
Oh,
please.
I'm suddenly regretting.
Your
just
stage presence is so incredible.
I feel like suggestion equals volunteer.
But now everybody on the stream is going to realize that I can't read.
It's okay. Your brain was. So this side is just story text, right. And this side is the puzzle text. So
okay.
I would read just this.
Just this. Okay.
Yes.
Thank God. Okay.
He's like.
Yeah. No, don't read the whole page.
We do have.
Stay behind me, Kali. All right. So.
Oh yes, Moonlight Sonata.
Ooh.
Good choice.
Yeah, Beethoven.
Some accoutrements for the well-armored warrior are anagrammed below in pairs. The letters for each numbered grid can be scrambled into the names of the two weapons, except the crossing letter has been removed from the anagram. For example, if given a bug vice, you might add an L to the crossing square to make glaive and club. After you've unscrambled the weapons and put them into their grids, the crossing letter, read in order, will reveal how you might get your weapons, which is also your keyword. What is the keyword?
So the interesting thing about this book is it's divided into four sections. Each one has a meta puzzle. A meta puzzle uses content from other puzzles to solve it. Yeah, we're high level with our puzzles. We're snooty. So meta puzzles are one of the greatest things
on Earth. But
still
family friendly.
Still family friendly. It is great for families to do together. So your keyword for each puzzle here. One, the keyword lets you know that you've done the puzzle and you finished it correctly, because otherwise you get gibberish. And two, you use it for your meta puzzle for this section, which will get used in a meta puzzle, which gets used in all of the sections.
Oh my god.
That's
it's so cool. You should get this book.
Yeah, I know a dozen people who are suddenly my gifts checked off.
Yeah. Right, Joe, it's a cool book.
I just heard a meta puzzle.
Oh yeah.
Meta puzzle, Joe.
Meta squared.
So this is really unfortunate for me because I'm not very familiar with medieval weapons, besides S words.
Also, we're kind of we're running out of time.
Time is dwindling.
And also, this is a little generous,
right?
Okay.
Because normally
we forgot to restart it.
Yeah, we're out of time, like right around now. Like 8 o'clock.
Ooh.
Okay.
But I mean, I think we have the core here. We don't need to finish it. We have the game.
Should we welcome our friends over?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, let's play this for real. And if we have a puzzle showdown,
okay.
Let's set up for them. Let's kind of declutter the table.
Do I have to be a shark for this too?
All right, we have the command.
Okay, give me the people cards because I want to make backs for them real quick.
Sure.
Yeah. So we know.
We have more people cards.
Yeah, because it's just like a sea.
All the command cards are over here.
I have some too.
This one.
Black
and
did not know what they're.
That is correct.
Patrick.
So this is Patrick from
Uncle's Game.
Oh, hi.
Hi, Patrick.
Hey.
Hello. I've been on before. Some of you see me.
So ETX starts tomorrow.
It starts tomorrow at
noon.
What's
kicking it off?
I think the very first competitive event is Imperial Assault, which is a sweet Star Wars game. And then we move into like Game of Thrones Melee, X-Wing, Flight 1 starts, everything. It goes crazy.
What
Friday starts to blow up fast.
What ships are you flying, Zach?
That they all exist.
Me, personally?
Oh, Zach.
I don't know that he wants to put the word out.
Only the Empire.
Only
right. There is one true Emperor.
Some palp aces or something going on.
Alright, we have some new people.
I have no idea what's going on here. I saw just brief glimpses, so you will definitely have to actually teach the game.
We also have
I see TIE fighters in Las Vegas,
yeah.
So
could it
that
better?
Bodes well.
I don't think so.
Some community members here.
Hello,
we
everybody.
We have Andrew and what do you call yourself? Ricky Zargaros?
Yeah. Whatever.
Alright. So these guys are totally new, fresh eyes and ears, so this is a good time to test if our game actually makes sense. Playtesting.
We'll find out.
It's gonna be so fun.
All right.
Did we come up with a name for a game, or did I already do
that's
that?
That's very important.
Is it called The Search of Alientology?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Yes.
It almost rhymes.
Almost rhymes.
Yeah.
All right, something we forgot to do at the beginning of our turn was automatically move these TIE fighters.
Should we roll dice?
One more?
Yeah,
absolutely.
For each TIE fighter,
boy.
And then move them.
Yeah, I think you roll one.
Start that's by one picking your character.
Just pick
a character you want to play.
Am I allowed to look at them?
Yeah, I'll shout out, guys.
Oh.
What are we waiting for? What's going on?
Okay. So we're going to have Ryan, Andrew, Ricky and Patrick as kind of our new players.
Yeah, these cards
are
sweet.
Let's
do it. I'm gonna be Goku.
Do I have to pick a color?
Yeah.
This actually is just
actually really no. We have
cool.
Numbered player tokens on your seat.
Oh.
We had component limitations.
We need little minis or something.
The chef.
Yeah, come on, aren't you Fantasy Flight?
This is
Where is the plastic?
I am on vacation.
I want plastic.
This is the prototype. Well, obviously, we have two beautiful skull mints.
Joe, give me minis.
Ricky.
We have the board from Lords of Vegas. We have the miniatures from X-Wing.
Okay.
We have, what is the brains and are these?
Credits from Netrunner.
Yeah, from okay. Netrunner.
Brain damage tokens. Brain damage tokens.
Yeah, the brain damage tokens.
Yep.
And then we also have, where did the chips come from?
I think they're the Vegas things.
That's Vegas things.
Yes.
So, yeah, we're using
and dice from the Vegas things.
And then yeah.
We're actually
also
using quite a few things for the Vegas.
Yeah.
We have a final showdown tiebreaker puzzle from.
This?
Oh, no. Your
this
character.
Awesome puzzle.
Oh, this is my character.
Pick one.
Thanks for the resub, Prometheus.
No,
sure,
no, else. Thank
you. Oh, okay. Got it. There you go.
Bring it on in. Okay, and how many players? Raise your hand if you're in.
I'm in.
So four. Is it just the
I
one,
think it
two,
should
four?
Be the
four?
New, four. New players.
Okay,
yeah.
Just four.
So we remove the number five chip from there.
Yeah, we can just take that number five out.
Okay.
That's done.
Fast.
Oh,
so
I didn't catch.
One.
What is the name of this game?
It's The Search of Alientology.
Can you read, Brian?
I think that.
Oh, if I read the card, I could have been confused.
I don't know about sales on a game called Search of Alientology, but you know.
It's a working title. All
right.
Have we determined a new goal for the aliens in this particular?
Only.
Am I an alien?
We should get them
to
show
anyone. I don't know.
Yeah. So this is a hidden role game. John, one of you is an alien.
Oh.
The aliens are trying to find a certain combination of people that are on the Vegas Strip.
Represented by those tokens.
Yep. The rest of you are an anti-alien cult, is that what we determined?
Something like that.
Yeah, something like that. Who are trying to just convert people.
They're trying to purge.
I like your version better.
I'm really envisioning this on the Strip. Like, I've been to Las Vegas. I can see myself walking around as an anti-alien cult member trying
right.
to kill aliens.
So, no, you're trying to purge the aliens from Earth to send them out of back to outer
no
space.
No killing? Is this a no,
well, well, no,
let's
no,
catch
no, no,
and release?
Because of the theme of this episode of Grab Bag is ritual.
Oh.
We do a special ritual to try to purge them and send them to outer space.
Got it.
Unfortunately, whoa. If they are actually human beings, they just turn into aliens.
Yep. They become brainwashed and want to help the aliens.
Yeah.
The ritual fails.
So
yes.
If I try and brainwash a human who is not an alien, they become an alien.
And then they are suddenly helping whoever the secret
they
alien is.
They and whoever
oh.
they have captured.
Okay. Okay.
Ritual.
If it comes down to two players, which one will be the alien and one is the human, you reveal both those players, and the aliens all join teams to solve a puzzle.
An
and
Earth
player,
puzzle.
An Earth puzzle, and the player has to do it on their own.
Oh gosh. All right. This is my favorite ritual.
Welcome
I'm
to
glad that
the
I'm an alien
of
and
alien
I have
alien
yeah,
I love
you, I
alien
you
purge
a
season.
With a lot of the cats,
okay.
So
all right.
Every
so
season walk
the
alien purge.
Yep.
Do we want to have new alien win condition or the same color?
I think we should give them a new one.
I'll make a new one.
All right. So there is one alien among you, and he is attempting to collect. What are you having him collect over there?
Let's do one yellow. Oh, that's pretty
it's
mischievous.
So
one yellow, one green, and one blue.
So the aliens win when they have one of each of those captured, and as soon as that happens, they start dancing and reveal that they're the aliens.
Your best alien dance. You also do an ET run.
So the players win when they either find the alien or collect 10 total people.
Okay.
See.
And when they collect 10 total people, you have to finish the round that they did that in for it to be successful. So the way the turn structure is going to work is you guys are each going to be dealt four cards. If you can shuffle those cards up and
oh, they've been shuffled.
Okay, there are four different actions. One action is move. When you move, you get to roll one die. You get to move that many spaces. Whatever space you're on, you'll flip a tile over. So go ahead and flip one of those tiles over. I just want to show you how it works.
Sure.
So you flip it over and you pull it off, and it's a color. So purple represents
blue.
Blue.
What was it? Yeah, blue.
So you take a blue and you put it on that space.
Okay.
Hmm.
When you move to that space, that's what happens. You also have, what's the reveal called? Solve?
Solve. Yeah.
It says solve and then parentheses.
No, stay.
Stay.
So okay. you have stay, you have move, so you move to a space and reveal.
Okay.
You have stay.
Okay.
If you look, there's different hotels on the board.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
When you stay, you can choose any tile in your hotel and you flip it over.
Okay.
So you can see what color it is and then you replace it with a color.
Okay.
When you solve, you roll two dice. And what you're doing, if you were number one, player number one over there, you roll two dice, and you have to roll a three. If you roll a three,
or
you get
higher.
or higher.
Yeah, oh, that okay. number or higher.
If you look, he's next to a three, right?
Okay.
So he would capture that person, or he'd get, a, he would get that token. So
I
that's
see.
How you collect the token.
Got it.
Is when
Got
you
it.
Solve.
Got it.
And then the final and most interesting thematic part of the game is the ritual.
Okay.
So when a ritual gets revealed, what happens is the cult leader, whoever has the blue X-Wing right there,
mm-hmm. yep.
Is going to name another player.
Okay.
That is a player they're essentially accusing of being the alien. Then every player that is not an outed as an alien at that point is going to cast a vote with the remaining cards in their hand. So they're going to choose one of them. If you look at the cards, can you show one of those cards? They have numbers on them.
There's a vote.
So you're going to, when you do a ritual, everyone's going to cast a vote.
Okay.
Everyone that's not an alien.
Right. Well.
Everyone's not revealed to be.
Got you.
Yeah. So
if
then.
If you want, we can just start playing.
Yeah.
And I think
yeah.
you should learn.
Okay. So
we'll find this.
Cult leader is going to be.
Well, I'm not the alien, so I'm not worried about anything.
Not according to chat.
The chat was like Rai, the traitor guy.
Who's? All right, you're the cult leader. All right. So what's going to happen is go ahead and deal out four cards to everybody.
All right.
Pretty.
There's
cool.
some. Battlestar Galactica feeling I'm getting.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Battlestar Dead of Winter. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Those are the two that come to mind. I'm
so sure I'll know the alien by the way you dance, probably. So.
Yep.
How do aliens dance?
Yeah, I'm not. I was gonna say
how do you guys like to dance? It's the real question.
Okay. So you're getting your hands now.
Okay.
That's your hand of cards. Don't show those to anybody.
All right.
You're each going to choose one of those, and that's going to go into a combined stack of actions that will all resolve this turn. So all choose right, one, right. and you'll put it in the middle. And whoever the cult leader is going to shuffle that up, and then we'll reveal one at a time, and we'll show you how that works.
And so, like, I'm... Which number am I?
You're number four.
Okay.
So, one, two, three, four.
Got it.
Okay. So we make a combined...
A combined stack.
Stack in the middle.
Okay.
All right, and since I am the cult leader...
Right.
You shuffle those up.
And definitely not an alien.
Right.
And then reveal the top one.
Top card?
Reveal yeah. the
Starting
top
with
card.
With the cult leader. You're gonna move. Everyone's gonna move.
All right,
roll moving.
Show that so people
so
know.
So number one, you're gonna move. Roll a die.
Okay.
Roll.
Do the red die for movement.
Red die for movement?
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm number one.
You can move one space.
Okay. All right, so might as well move to the blue.
Yeah, right. And then you
see
would,
what's going
when
on
you
there?
Move there, you reveal it, so that then it would become the blue that it already is.
Okay.
Okay.
Right.
All right, then the next player moves, so you roll the red.
Yep. Go for it.
Here you go.
We can all have dice.
Oh, perfect.
There's lots of dice.
What?
One?
I did bump it to keep it from falling off the table.
Is
that
a full on
reroll?
So you move the space.
All right.
And then you flip it over. And now you grab a yellow coin and replace the cardboard piece.
Cool.
And then you're on that space.
Sweet.
And then number three goes. So you roll a red.
Yeah.
One.
All right.
Well,
so number three gets to move the space.
I'm calling shenanigans.
And it's important to note, any the
They're
three
all aliens.
The TIE fighters block an entire row.
Okay.
So you
Whoever.
Cannot capture a token from that row.
Can you pass
okay.
through that row?
You can.
Okay.
You
can.
The only thing you can't
so
do
you're
capture.
Like running.
They'll move.
All right.
They'll move just around the board.
Gotcha.
At the end of each round. Just one space.
I think we determined.
Patrick,
if
you roll a one.
I'm
mean,
if you don't roll a one, when you play Lords of Vegas, you're like. When you roll the die,
so that's how I'm feeling right now because there's a Vegas board in front of me.
Whoa!
Oh,
no way!
The ritual!
No way!
What are the odds?
The ritual! All
right.
Did
all
Zach right. touch right. these dice?
You move number one.
Scream! What are the odds?
It's whatever 1 in 36.
Are you yeah, no.
You're
I'm...
player four. Yeah, there you go. Right,
that's
so
you reveal amazing. That?
I have
a green. So you're placing with the green.
All right. These dice explain a lot about my plays as Lord of Vegas.
That
well.
Cardboard token.
Oh,
got it. Okay. And so that's the move. Now the cult leader reveals the next card in the stack.
Ritual.
Okay, so this is the only one that everyone doesn't actively do a ritual, but you do as the cult leader.
Okay.
So you choose another player who you think is the alien.
Patrick's the alien.
All right, Patrick's the alien.
He's the tallest.
So now every player, because no one has a brain damage alien token yet, every player casts a vote from their hand. What matters on your vote is the number. So you take the total number of players left right now that are not aliens, which is 4, times 3. 3 for each player.
Okay.
So 12. The total number of votes has to be greater than 12 for you to be convicted as an alien.
Right.
Do I get to vote too?
Everyone gets to vote.
Right.
That is not doesn't have brain damage. Brain damage means you don't vote here.
Okay.
So if you don't want to be outed, you might cast a low number card, right?
If you want to be outed.
Yeah, I got it.
All right, so you put that in the combined stack in the middle.
All face down?
Yep.
Yep.
You're not going to know who voted what. Shuffle them up as the cult leader.
And then reveal and tally up the numbers.
I am definitely not the silo. I mean, alien. Definitely not.
Quick question. So I did take the fives out because we're playing with four players instead of five. Is that going to affect the count on?
I don't think so.
You shouldn't? Okay. Perfect. Good luck.
don't play with less than three players.
Yes.
Yeah. It's a 3 to 5 player.
So we've got a 1 point, 4 point,
wow,
5 point, and then 3 points.
So total. What's the total?
So wait. That's math is hard. It's 9 points.
Nice. Nine.
Oh, no. So you're not,
you survived. And then now
you survived the ritual.
Shuffled up and dealt back out.
What?
All right. Then after the ritual.
Face down and randomly. Yeah. You might just eventually get nothing but moves.
And then right. For the ritual, you guys needed to like what? Circle
to
around me.
Redistribute those. Yeah. After.
We're limited with space.
Do incantations. All right.
So then you reveal the next card.
There's a lot of other cards I don't want mixed in. All right.
Oh, which one is your hand?
Oh God! What have I done?
That one, yeah.
I think that's the. Yeah, reveal.
Put the X-wing on top
so
of your.
So there's
hand.
Move.
All right, move. So now the cult leader moves first. Roll red.
All right, here we go.
Two.
All right, I'm gonna move.
We're getting faster.
I'm gonna move across to here. See what we find.
Blue. So that's
blue. Blue.
So
another blue.
The couple we've taken.
And take the
cardboard goes.
And you're forced to move again. So if you do, if you want to move to a space where you want to collect that color token, you would want to communicate with the other humans. I'm going to play a move this turn. Nobody else play one.
Right. So if you are an alien, like the chat room suspects, you want to collect one yellow, one green, and one blue. Right?
Yeah, there needs to be like a inserted like discussion phase prior to voting.
Right? Ryan accusing people a lot? Agreed.
I noticed
agreed, chat room.
I noticed that a lot of rituals were wasted there.
I forgot your name. What's your name?
Ricky?
Ricky is a little quiet, though. And quiet is dangerous.
Hey, I got my green card. I'm not illegal.
Three!
One, two, three.
Let's go. One. Can we move diagonal?
Yes.
One, two, three.
Okay. So reveal that.
Got a good feeling about this.
So that's blue.
That's a blue.
Lots of blues. Did anybody shuffle these?
Blue's pretty cool. It's only blues, actually.
So do we, I forget what these gems represent, like people.
Yeah.
Trying to collect people.
Yep. Here.
Okay.
Vacationers.
Once you're an alien. Right.
Blackjack dealers.
Well, no. Both people are trying
to. So one of the actions is taking those off the board.
Yes.
And that action was called solve. Okay.
So cultists, they obviously want to collect people to their cult to, you know, help them. Reveal more aliens.
Got it.
Aliens want to abduct more brains.
So it's more like.
It's called, it should be called recruit.
Recruits.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Exactly. Recruit is much.
Because it works for either side. Mm-hmm.
Yep.
What?
Let's see.
Five.
Ooh.
Let's see.
Different kind of brainwashing.
Sure, play old Age of Empires.
One.
On PC. Two, send out like a little prophet
five.
Guy.
A
and
monk,
then come
you
back
mean?
With like. A monk?
Whoa,
come back with
yeah.
That's what I was imagining.
All the blues. Okay,
we got all the blues, guys.
Alright, let's do it.
That's how I feel.
We got the blues.
Five,
I believe
five.
The five is mine. Let's move those red dice away. Alright.
What about the street? Do I have to like frog her across or
so
what?
Is that
two?
One, two? It costs two to move.
A three.
Uh-huh.
It should cost a lot more than that. I've been to Vegas. Four. Five. Alright.
Oh.
I got. What does this mean?
Whoa.
Do I get
bonus?
Two?
It's yellow.
All right.
Oh.
All right.
Cool. All
right. So that's the end of that move. Reveal the last
so
card in the stack.
Okay. And then when do the patrols move again?
Once this is over.
So this is it. Okay. Solve.
All right.
Okay. So this is recruit.
Yep. Right,
for better terms. So
yes.
you start. You can recruit. What number are you? One.
I'm number
so
one.
Two dice.
Okay.
And you're next to a three or a five, so you need a five or better.
So does only he get to recruit?
Interesting. Wait, what is the number?
Awesome.
Oh, it's the five on there. Okay, so I need to get a five or better.
I spy a rye spy guy.
I got a six?
Yeah.
Yes. So you take the blue token. Woo. You get it. As a player.
Throw Ryan out the airlock. I don't think that's
right. So now you get a solve.
Does that airlock work back there?
Where am I? I'm number
right two.
This one.
Yep.
Okay, so I need to roll four. Or more.
Re-rolling.
Cock die, re-roll.
Cock die.
Got
it.
Okay. Six. Nice. Definitely.
Awesome.
I got some blue.
Oh, so you have to roll high. Oh, one die must be higher than.
Yeah.
I need a three.
I landed well.
Got it.
I got it.
Ooh. What are the aliens need to win?
One yellow, one green, and one blue.
And we're five away from victory.
All right. I just need a two or higher on two dice. That really shouldn't be too hard, right?
Got it.
All right.
Easy money.
All right. So that's the end of the round?
Where does this guy go? No.
You keep it.
All right. Cool.
The TIE Fighters move is, or the, are we rolling for the TIE Fighters?
I think so too.
Thank you. Cult leader, roll a die. Whoa, TIE Fighters, that's hilarious. Cult leader, roll a die.
Just like in the theater.
Yes, all right, just that one die?
Yep.
Okay.
Amazing sound effects, Joe. Right.
So the TIE Fighters already moved one, they move three more.
Okay. Ooh. Hmm. Your columns.
Yeah.
So remember, you cannot recruit anything in the column of the TIE Fighter. Or the row.
Yeah.
Right?
Oh.
Okay.
Or in this case,
so
the Vegas
now
control.
Those four actions that just got revealed, shuffle them up, deal them back out.
Okay.
Then you're going to pass the X-Wing Cult Leader marker to the next player, and he's going to take over that role.
Guys, for some of the new people joining in, we are playing a board game designed by board games. This show is called Grab Bag at Hyper RPG.
All right.
All right.
Cult
leader.
Me?
Your turn.
Everyone has to votes for the turn.
Okay.
Supreme Xenomorph.
So we all put in our card.
We all put in one card, yeah.
I don't like any
of
my cards.
What actually do you want to happen this turn? You can discuss it too. It's like, oh, no one else put in move.
How many?
I put in a move, by the way. I can say it's like
you can
that.
Say that. You all right. Totally
so I put in a move. If somebody could put in like a recruit, that would be awesome. Because if we all just move around and don't recruit people, then the humans are going to lose this game, and that's going to suck.
But we could also throw in rituals and find the alien and purge them.
Yeah, but
and if you get a ritual and it happens and you get it wrong,
I don't know why you would recommend that, because if that happens, it's you that we're going to...
Last game, everybody turned into an alien because we...
Failed rituals. That's what happens in a cult, right?
As far as I can
Doesn't
tell...
Doesn't it happen often in cults that
I don't know.
People
you
become
tell me.
Aliens?
Oh, yeah, for sure.
It's a different kind of brain abduction.
Gotcha.
No one else is saying that they're not an alien besides me, so I think I'm most clearly the most not alien.
Clearly, so Ryan is.
Yes. Yeah, right.
Definitely.
It's a very alien thing
alien.
To say.
Yep.
He's
yep.
clearly.
Solid argument.
To be declarative and to explain who you are.
Why does he have his hand behind his back? Is that some kind of alien hand?
Yeah, I don't know.
Hello, human. My name is John.
Can I be your human friend?
And I'm definitely a human.
Can we do other human things?
I think once alien revealed, they need to talk like that.
Let's go inside and watch the glowy box. I hear Game of Thrones is on.
All right, so those are shuffled.
Now you reveal the top one.
Yep.
All right.
So this is a
move.
All right,
so
get
I get
first.
To start.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes, this one. Five.
That's a number lot of two.
One, two, three,
four.
Five. It is yellow.
Interesting.
Yes.
If you weren't an alien, you probably would have just gone for another blue.
Yeah. Exactly. Right?
All right.
Yeah.
Ricky, roll.
Totally.
Five.
This guy is the alien.
One, two, three, four. About there.
Now you won't be able to recruit there. Are you sure you want to?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, you can't.
Just saying. Notice team player.
Can I go back into his square? Can we fight over that recruit?
You can both be there.
Yep.
So you're both Ooh. Potentially aliens.
Oh, is that like?
Yeah.
Who's this?
I don't
That's me.
All right, got it. Cool. Try and to conceal. roll a die. Two, no one die. A three.
Three.
One, two, three. I'll go right next to you guys.
Yep. That's green.
And remember, you can recruit in the space next to you.
You know what kind of people hang out over here?
Aliens.
Humans.
I can't recruit here?
Humans, you can totally. That's a human area.
Oh, okay. Ryan. Cool. Oh. Oh. Nice.
Two.
Oh, but I can't go recruit there.
Right.
So I have to go to a potential unknown.
Right. Knowing what I know about Lords of Vegas.
One, two.
These are going to be all the high numbers.
One, two. Here we go.
They're on the strip.
Come on, show me blue. That's blue. All right.
Tricky.
Oh, somebody wants a blue, huh? All
right.
Yeah, because only aliens want different colors.
In the final version,
or maybe that's something that alien wants everyone to think.
Cult leader.
That's just the rules.
All right, cult leader. All right.
What this game really needs is a Simpsons license.
Salt.
So this is recruit.
Okay.
Starting with you, you can recruit.
Okay.
Two decks. Numero two.
And wait, the number on there is three.
You did not get it
earlier.
No.
Also, before rolling, you have to declare who you're trying to recruit.
Right.
Because you can recruit.
Because you could have recruited my green guy, who's
any
a six.
Adjacent? Right.
Oh.
Okay. Well.
Be aware.
Didn't do it anyways.
Number three. Who are you trying to recruit?
Where I'm at. Where he failed.
All right.
Definitely got five it. And one.
No problem.
Cold coffee is awesome.
Right?
That's unfortunate.
Humans love cold coffee.
All right, recruit.
I'm gonna go ahead and point out that very alien thing that he just did.
Yeah.
Oh, six.
All right, so how did the aliens win again?
It's also an eight.
Another so very alien thing to do.
How did the aliens win?
Blue, green, yellow.
Blue, green, yellow.
Yeah, one blue. What are
these aliens?
Yeah, so. You're now one step away from proving yourself to be the alien.
But you guys also have currently six total tokens. So once you get to eight, that's the last round.
Blue, green, yellow.
Do I win on a tie?
You didn't get a tie.
Oh, because you don't add them up.
Yeah,
never mind. Oh, I failed.
All right, Overlord, Cult Leader, reveal the next card.
All right. Let's send Patrick out the airlock.
Come on.
Let's.
Oh, let's do this again.
Yeah.
But there's nobody to recruit around us.
Hmm.
Well, that one's diagonal.
Hmm.
Yeah, you could go on the diagonal.
Yeah. Let's go for it.
Four.
So I'm rolling for that.
Can you get it?
No, it's blocked.
That's blocked.
Oh, it's blocked! Okay, yeah. Never mind.
No, you three can't recruit. Number one can, though.
Don't worry, guys. I'll take care of this.
Got it.
No problem. Just doing my part, not taking multiple colors.
So the aliens could be throwing in a second recruit, thinking they've already got their guys on the first recruit to sabotage. Except the alien also wants to recruit.
Yeah.
An alien can also, in a ritual, convert another alien if they convince everyone to throw someone out in the airlock.
And whoever gets converted to an alien, their tokens start counting to the alien token.
And they're removed from the players.
Okay, that makes me less wanting to throw people into space.
Yeah.
I don't know.
So now Overlord gets to reveal the next card.
Sounds like alien talk to me.
Oh, one more card.
I think everybody's inkling about
Cult Leader and
is everyone ready?
I mean Space Cat.
Space Cat is
not
ready.
Not alien.
Move.
No
rituals.
All right.
To finish it off, move.
All right, so starting with you, you get a roll and move.
Okay. One.
Let's just go right here.
I would Flipper. Go back.
Back.
Because the X-Wing is going to move.
Well, the TIE Fighter is going to
But the X-Wing
roll.
Will probably move more than one.
Excuse me. Yeah.
So it's definitely.
Yeah, but you can't cross the
street. Green! Ooh. Yeah.
Don't like that.
All right.
Yeah.
So now you move. Six. Wow. It's pretty crazy because the TIE Fighters can get real crazy in this.
One.
Yeah, I like that they're in the columns now.
Yeah.
Well, I just like the fact that they can move one or six.
Mm-hmm.
Like.
Four, five, six.
Oh, MCS has a good point. I'm a space cat that makes me an alien by default.
So it's blue?
Yep. All the blues. Alright, you're
up. Extraterrestrial doesn't necessarily mean
Yeah. Uh-oh, man down, man down.
What is it? What is it?
Oh, you want to keep
it? No, you gotta re-roll that.
It's a six.
Nothing counts off the table.
A three. Look at that, how that popped up on there. All right. So.
These dice have character today.
One, two. I want to stop here.
Can't.
Oh, is this, if I go here, does that still adjacent?
It's across the street.
Dang it. I definitely don't want to go to that blue street.
Yeah. All right.
I wonder why you're trying to get that blue. Are you an alien?
What? He doesn't know. Stay away from it.
That's red.
All right.
Because he has a yellow and green.
Uh-oh.
And he needs a blue. Red. Why are you looking for a blue?
Luckily, reds are good for us. Reds are great.
All right, so number one gets to move.
All right, that's me. Four.
Nice.
All right. Let's see. One. And does this count to cross?
No,
well?
Just the main strip costs two.
Cool. Then I'll go up here.
Red.
Oh, a red. Perfect. Oh! Cheater, alien.
Just like an alien.
Yeah. Are you taking a little peek at a second tile?
I will not go there. I'll abstain from that spot.
Roll for the TIE Fighter Patrol.
There we go. It's only fair.
Roll again for the fighters. He's not the... Oh.
Okay.
Cult leader.
Yes.
Mea culpa.
Absolutely.
One.
That's
interesting.
Okay, and then as the cult leader, you pass the X-Wing and reshuffle those cards and deal them out.
All right.
And how many total tokens are out right now? Seven?
Kind of wish you could, pitch a second card. So kind of get stuck with three cards.
Two, three, four, five, six of them. So we're one away from victory.
You should have gone four, because you had to deal with that. Okay.
And be aware, when the 8th token gets picked up, you finish the stack of cards.
Yeah, still have to
finish that round.
Okay.
Because someone could be converted to an alien that round.
Alright guys,
aliens could win in the meantime.
Right.
I have only solve and ritual, and I'd rather throw down a solve than a ritual, but what do you guys think?
Ritual.
Sounds like ritual.
There have not been enough wild accusations.
Yeah, I know.
Give the people what they want. I'm gonna go ahead and ritual.
I will throw down ritual. We can just go ritual.
I'm totally cool with that. The most helpful alien I have ever seen.
What are all these
seen?
Guys?
Ritual.
Guys, did you all put ritual?
Oh, it's gonna be a ritual party.
Just getting back at me,
Ricky. What did you put?
I know it.
Why would you like to
know? Ritual asking?
Party. Why are you being so secretive? We should be working together. If we're humans, then we should be working together.
Gabby, no.
Just human.
Unless you're an alien.
Job of working.
I don't know about that either.
He has been really quiet.
If you are a human, you would want to cooperate.
I played Resistance. I played One Night Werewolf. It's the quiet ones. Chat, am I right? It's the quiet ones.
I don't know.
Ones.
Why did you want it to get the blue?
It's the quiet.
Why would no one put down a solve or a move when all we have to do is solve one more to win?
I did put down a solve.
Because you said.
Sounds like aliens.
Do that.
Are these your tokens, though?
Yeah, that's mine.
Oh, where are your tokens? You haven't collected any?
No, he's got two right there.
Oh, two, okay.
He's one away from being an alien.
He's also one away from being an alien.
Yeah, you two guys
and
definitely
he,
can't
and
be trusted.
And he was trying to see if he'd get my blue.
No, he wasn't.
No, I am. Yeah. I want his blue. I'll try to take
what?
It.
What?
I'll take whatever, man.
What did you just say? You would take a blue?
Isn't it good for the humans to collect tokens too?
No, we lose!
If we collect tokens?
No, only if the alien
gets it.
If you believe he's
an alien.
Since you're an alien.
Oh, okay.
Since you're definitely an alien. If you capture the blue,
if he's the alien, don't I want him not to get that?
He wouldn't want. If he's an alien, he wants to get the green ring.
I want a green.
Yeah, but
Joe, two people have glasses.
You're going to look very suspicious.
Joe, two people!
Three people.
I'm suspicious.
So it's the one.
Go ahead, see if I'm an alien. But what you will actually do is make me into an
alien. You're now the cult leader. So shuffle that pile up and then reveal.
There must be some sort of like Nietzsche quote for that.
I think Patrick's an alien now. That convinced me.
I think Joe's an alien.
Well, if we have a ritual, we'll be able to find out.
Yeah, let's find out.
Just a reminder.
Ritual.
Alright.
Sorry, wait, pause.
Just a reminder, Hyper RPG is a community-driven channel. We appreciate your follows and subscribes.
I want to move this.
This is Grab Bag. We're playing a board game made from board games.
If you guys are going to do a ritual around me, I think you need to do an actual ritual around me. That's all I'm saying.
Ritual.
You choose,
you choose an alien.
I don't know, you're kind of suspicious trying to get my blue there.
I'll tell you the truth. I think you're the alien, and I will come after you, so you should come after me.
Just like a real alien.
Just
that
telling you the truth. Huh? So I think you're the alien.
To the two humans here, why should we trust you?
To the two humans that are here, you should trust me because I'm not the alien. I don't know. I don't know what's going on, but I am not the alien.
Here's why you should trust
me. That's valid.
Anyways.
Because if I was the alien, I'd be much happier than I am right now. Because I love being
I think he's smiling through his teeth.
I like being the Cylon.
There's a little color in your cheeks, Patrick. I remember in Werewolf, when you were the werewolf, your cheeks got a little red.
That's probably true. That's probably true.
It is also
You are going to... It's going to be a self-fulfilling prophecy if you ritual me. That's all I'm saying. It will be a self-fulfilling... Because I will then be an alien, and I will destroy you all. And I have two colors already.
It's true. It's dangerous.
All right, let's do this.
I'm just saying.
Yep.
Right, that is why you should do it.
Let's do it. Right.
Come on.
It's a good idea doing the three separate colors.
Everybody vote.
Real good.
Somebody drop a
call. So, Gabby, yeah, were you on the group of people at Penny Arcade Expo for Lone Shark who had to make a game in like an hour?
I was. I was on the panel. We made Meet Your Maker, and that's meat with an EA. As a vegetarian, I was so displeased.
What did Joe say?
You were displeased with being a vegetarian?
No, with having to make a game about meat. It was so sad.
Get in the shot.
Gabby, I guess you're gonna get the shot. You should tell them about Meet Your Maker because that game was hilarious, and you made it in like an hour.
We had an hour to make a game live in a panel, and so we had like paper craft eight-sided dice that we drew little symbols on. The audience was throwing out crazy suggestions. They were helping us build the theme. They were building the backstory. Like, it was nuts.
Who was on the panel? It was
Elisa, also from Lone Shark Games. Paul Peterson from PopCap, and Liz Spain from Lone Shark Games, and oh man, there was someone else, and I'm a jerk.
Somebody wasn't somebody from Penny Arcade on there too?
Krahulik and Jerry helped moderate with Mike Selinker.
Oh, okay.
I feel like someone else helped us make the game, and I'm sorry I forgot them. Because probably you're one of my coworkers.
Hey guys.
All right.
Voted for the alien.
All right.
12, right?
Yep. Bring it on.
We got. Three.
Ooh.
Four.
Ooh.
Seven.
It's looking good.
Eight.
All right.
Nine.
Fail ritual.
All right, so let's get shuffled.
You have made the right decision. You have made the right decision.
Boo.
Ryan, don't give me that look. That's suspicious. I really think he's the alien, but you really want me to come after you. All right, Ryan. All right.
This is your card.
Just taking a good look. Making sure those aren't alien eyes I'm staring into.
I think the quiet one's the alien.
You're both suspicious as hell. There's no doubt about it.
I'm missing it.
Don't we have to flip over another card? Aren't things happening now?
Yep.
Judge!
Solve!
So that's recruit.
Okay.
Cool.
Remember, you can't recruit in the rows of the TIE Fighters.
Oh!
I'm gonna roll TIE Fighters.
There are the limited options.
Oh yeah, I need two dice. So I need...
I should be going elsewhere.
Six.
Six. God.
Did the
didn't get it.
Nope.
All right, number four. You can't recruit anybody.
I can't recruit.
Number one.
No recruit.
Can't recruit anybody. Number two.
I can't recruit anyone.
Number two.
You can.
Number four. Nope.
The four. Yeah, the yellow.
Yeah.
Right there.
Oh yeah, the.
Yeah.
Yep.
Join Do us. It. Join the Rebel Alliance.
Didn't get it. Oh no. Again. It could have been game.
Ready? Not a ritual.
So close.
Another ritual, who's it gonna be?
Here I am.
Alright.
I think Patrick's the alien.
Yeah. I do not think I'm the alien.
I'm putting my full vote in for it.
Alright. Problem is, people are oh no, we dealt the cards back out.
Mm-hmm.
I was gonna say, maybe you shouldn't have the cards be dealt back out because then people are gonna use their low numbers early, but they'll start to run out of them.
No.
Until the end, you know what I'm saying?
Four.
Oh. Hey, evil penguin feet.
Ten.
And
12!
Out there, Locke, nope. You go!
Alright.
There's gotta be more, right?
12.
Right. We switched it because he took the 5 down.
Ah.
Alright, so.
Reveal.
Let's do the ritual thing. I have to reveal? Why would you do that to me, guys?
Oh!
Alright.
You're and a people.
Where's the brains?
I tried to warn you.
You're an alien. Now, what does the alien need to win?
One yellow, one green, no. One blue.
If the aliens have a yellow, green, and blue among them, they win right now.
Yep.
Ah! Ha!
Oh!
No!
Oh!
Suck it!
Oh, aliens!
Yeah! Woo!
Team aliens!
Like a certain part of you.
All right.
Like
brought it all together.
Ricky, why are you so suspicious? You were so unwilling to cooperate.
All right, team alien! All
All right.
Congratulations. So that was like perfect.
All that really matters is that I won, even though that was like close. I was converted into the win.
I want to say a special thank you to
Zach.
Zach from Team Covenant. That's you're going to be at ETX this weekend. Gabby from Lone Shark, who also wore the Sharky costume. Come on, Chad, show her some love.
I love the Sharks.
Your name's Nathan.
Nathan! You're so good at this.
From the University of Washington, an artist, and they're doing a lot of cool stuff over there. You should check it out for sure. And Ian.
Hi, everybody.
From Asmodee Final Fantasy Flight.
Technically, I work for Asmodee North America, but I'm here on vacation to go to Patrick's amazing convention.
Awesome.
Oh, thanks.
Since ETX is coming this weekend, why don't you tell the chat room a little bit about it? If you
Ticket sales are still going. They're at etxwa.com, and the ticket prices all go up by $5 tomorrow, basically at midnight tonight, because door prices are more than pre-ordering. So if you're coming out, please pick up your tickets tonight, because you don't want to pay an extra $5 at the door.
Yeah, etxwa.com.
There is a ton of events going on, some of it related to like Fantasy Flight competitive stuff, but I wish I could show you all the play to win titles. So play to win means that you basically play board games, and when you return that board game, you get a voucher, a raffle ticket, and at the end of each night, we raffle off all the games that you played. And there are hundreds of play to win titles. So I think everybody is gonna like walk away from this convention with like it's gonna be awesome. Last year we actually had some X-Wing players who were like, wait a second, if I just go play those games, I can win them, and they quit X-Wing and went and played play to win like the whole weekend.
Don't do that though, maybe.
So yeah, it's gonna be awesome down in Tacoma this weekend. And Malika's gonna be there doing interviews.
Yay.
There's a independent board game design contest going on. Yeah, competition, and it's down to 8 finalists. They're gonna be voted on by attendees there, and that's gonna go down to 3 or 2 finalists. And we're gonna have a board of panelists that, like, if you ever watch Tabletop Deathmatch, like Paul Peterson is gonna be on there. Mike Elliott's gonna be on there. A bunch of people, and they're gonna basically decide on what is the best game, and that wins a Lucci Award, which comes with prizes, helping to put that game into production. So there you go.
And so they're actually gonna make that game.
Wow. Yeah, well, we're helping to get them started in making that game.
And I get to interview all the people who are participating.
Yeah,
the finalists.
I've seen already emails flowing in to you.
Oh my goodness.
Different designers who want to get interviewed and stuff. So.
Yeah. Wow, that's super exciting.
Cool.
Anything else you want to be at
ETX tomorrow for a little bit. Some other Lone Shark folks will be there. Lisa and Marie and Shane and Aviva. They'll be running the Lone Shark Games playtest of a puzzle hunt that we run at Gen Con, so you can see it first there. And also going on this weekend locally is PaizoCon, and I will be there on Saturday and Sunday for a little bit. Panel at 2 p.m. on Saturday, and Sunday I'll be doing some demos of Mummy's Mask, the unreleased Pathfinder adventure card game.
I think Emily has something important to say here.
When we finish up, we're going to do a raid.
Oh,
domestic
are we
doing Dan.
A raid? Anything else?
We're also going to be at PaizoCon.
Yeah, sure.
Pop over really quick to tell everybody about that.
Emily, sorry, I'm totally still in your
way. Wrong way.
Made that harder.
Anna, Zach, and I are going to be at PaizoCon this weekend. We're going to be test running the Gauntlet, which is our new Pathfinder American Gladiator mashup show. So if you're going to be there, definitely check it out.
Yes.
Let me grab my computer and we'll do a raid as soon as
you're
ready.
Okay, I'm ready to do a raid. Thank you so much.
Only Team Covenant was broadcasting right now. You could raid them.
Everybody.
They'd be like, what is going on?
So thank you to all our guests who came. I'm looking forward to talking and interviewing some more.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Hey, I invited these guys to be on and they had no idea what they were in for. So thanks
Patrick
for being
Patrick basically
good
told me last
week,
clear your Thursday. I got something for you to do.
Oh,
okay, cool.
Thanks
that
for
shows
being a good
how much you trust him. Like, you know, there's like this thing.
Maybe a little
what do you
lower.
Think of Seattle?
No. It was great.
Cool. Oh, I didn't know.
Awesome.
Awesome.
Okay, guys, we had a very special guest during the charity stream. He was Domestic Dan. So everybody go to Domestic Dan Like, what's his address? Twitch.tv/domesticdan. It's linked in chat. Go! He likes to cook. I mean, it's pretty cool. He actually cooks and brings food here sometimes.
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 Two Nace, you are right. Mike Elliott and Paul Peterson have both been on the show in the past, so yes.
We've had some really awesome guests.
Yes, and more coming. Many, many more coming. I'm excited for you hosting, Alika. You're doing a great job.
Why, thank you,
You're
Patrick.
Yeah.
All right, are we hosting them?
Yes.
Okay, so we're off?
Yes.